When last we left off, we were going around. We were looking into getting Hutt and his frame.
Yes. We were on our way.
You guys had gone to an apartment building, a 10-story, rather unassuming parking building, apartment building, that doesn't exactly look like a stronghold where anything of importance would be kept. Going inside, there's no different interior. Like it really seems like an apartment building going inside. You guys have basically checked out the security on floor 5. Saw that it is inhabited. There's a dude there, but doesn't seem to give a shit about you guys. He doesn't seem to be looking for any type of interlopers, to your knowledge. You guys made your way up to the 8th floor and are about to make entry into this building. Now, I know that some of you guys, didn't listen to the whole episode again, but some of you guys stayed outside, I think. Some of you guys went inside, and I think the interior team, it's Complex, and then who else went in?
Hi.
Obviously, yeah, this guy.
Yeah, I think
I was outside.
Use Art Complex and Diz?
I think so, yeah. I think that's the door kickers.
If I am there, I am outside.
I'm at an abuela.
That was earlier that evening.
Yeah.
So we got Fuse. And then where's Jimbo?
Trying to remember.
I'm big. I'm strong. I'm smart.
Jimbo.
I'm fast.
I am Knuth.
Yes, you are, buddy. Don't forget to tell X to update your HP too.
Oh yeah, I need more because I'm a big tough guy now. Yeah. I'm physically tough. All right. I'm also mentally tough.
I am too.
To cocaine or jazz.
Because he is Knuth. How many hit points do you have?
55.
Yeah, we're the two boys with the 55 helmet? HP.
I am a gun.
Helmet.
That doesn't answer the question. What?
No armor on my dome. Just 7 from my skin weave.
Nope.
Nope.
No helmet.
Nope.
And then 11 from your armor jack?
That is correct.
We don't wear helmets.
No.
These heads are empty. The bolts will go right through them. We're main characters. So we can't wear helmets.
when someone shoots at me, I just line it up just right where it goes in one ear and out the other. And
what's your reflexes?
My reflexes?
Yep.
8.
Ooh, he's fast. He's fast. Me? I'm not so fast.
That's cool, but you don't have tech as a dump stat, so.
That's true.
Rest assured, you can still use your agent without getting mad at it.
I don't yell at my agent the way you do. What is your tech anyway? Is it like, what is it, like 4 or 3? 2? Holy shit, dude.
No, that's why I break so many phones, you know?
Yeah. You just throw them away every time. You're just like, what?
I just get so frustrated with whatever's going on that I just smash it. And they're like, you don't have to smash your phone. Huh?
Anything, he's pretty good at fucking breaking phones. Hell, he broke most of the group's phones twice.
That's true. Sometimes you just gotta yeet it off a building.
Give me your phone.
I still have a phone just because it's in my head.
That doesn't stop the phone's GPS from working.
It does if it gets smacked. Right? Right?
I don't know. Let's take a look and see if it actually smashed. Does it hit the ground?
That's our floor.
Do you really want to challenge me on that one? Because then I'll just be like, well, I guess you need to smash it more.
Yeah. All right, remember, guys, don't get shot.
Yeah.
Get shot?
Fucking complex. Don't get shot.
I haven't been shot yet. You've been shot.
Of course you've been shot.
Oh, I haven't been shot yet.
You fool.
I haven't been shot this month.
Oh, okay. All right, buddy.
He's a joker.
He's a something.
Something.
Oh, no, what I'm...
All right, so you guys can hear the low sound of, like, the air in the ducts up here on this floor. You guys are basically standing in front of the door.
Good if Hartman was actually playing the noise. I gotta turn it up a little bit.
Are we gonna breach?
I don't know.
Are you gonna pick the lock?
We might want
to make sure. Right.
Is there any sound coming from inside right now?
I put my ear up to the door.
Okay, you can hear what sounds like a small murmuring sound, maybe a tridio or something like that.
Oh.
Are there cameras currently looking at us right now?
In the hallways, yes.
I'm going to block.
Okay.
All right.
Go make a concentration roll for me, please. On 18, you see the light on the camera go dead as you're kind of like keeping it in your peripheral vision.
Got a good couple minutes at max.
All right.
We get in and see what we can do here?
Yeah.
All right, I wiggle past the group. Get down on one knee.
Is there a crack in the bottom of the door by chance or no?
There is, but any of your drones would have a hard time getting through this one.
I more just want to put I just want to put the camera down there and like peer through it.
Which camera?
The take Spider and like have Spider like lower itself down to the bottom, see if he can peek.
Gotcha.
Through.
Be right okay. back.
Sure. The feed from Spider is just basically showing, like, some dim light. It's not enough to actually really make anything out, but there is enough, like, light between the door and the frame.
Okay. So no movement, so to speak. So
yeah, you would see if someone walked up to the door and, like, you would see the shadow of, like, the interruption where their feet would be in the light beam, but, like, beyond that, you can't really make anything out.
Okay, I do have,
not
do
wide have... enough to get any real signal through, or, visual through.
I do have thermal, so is there any thermal signature?
Directly past the door? No, it doesn't look like it.
Okay. Is there any radiational from, like, anything that emits any type of radiation?
Doesn't seem like there's any kind of, radiation.
Okay. Well, there's not a small reactor in there. There's not somebody in there running a reactor in their chest. And nobody's running the microwave, so I think we're...
So we're just going to bust in there?
Yeah. Like... I think we... Well, maybe not bust. A nut. Maybe real yeah. real quiet, like...
No, dude, I'll bust a nut in there. Let's go. I'll just keep going.
You want
okay.
me to...
Okay, real talk, though. Do you want me to... like? Okay, if this is the apartment, right... let's do our due diligence, right? Is there a window we can get in through? Is there, like, is this on
the There would certainly floor? Be a fire escape that you right. can go to. It's up right. on 8, so you'd have to, the quickest way would be to go up across the roof and down.
Gotcha.
It was okay. also blocked off. We couldn't look in because everybody's trying in.
Gotcha. Okay.
With
so
the,
okay.
I would like to begin picking the lock.
Tinfoil on the windows.
Oh, I was gonna actually just we passed by the front office guy, right?
What do you mean? There was there's a rental office down below.
Yeah, and there was a guy.
Oh, you guys went to the security office. That's where it was on five.
No, that's fine. I could just make my face look like that guy and knock on the door.
Okay, but you need to go back and like study that guy's face.
I'm just posing it to the group.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, that would definitely.
I'm not saying. Oh, yeah, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm just like, hey, we could do. Like, I mean, we could pick the lock, or I could do that, or I guess we want to.
I begin picking the lock.
I mean, I think we're kind of like semi-hot right now at this point.
All right, cool.
Yep, I'm gonna, do terribly. Three.
I'm gonna go around to the fire.
So. Why do I have a 4 extra on my pick lock?
Okay.
What's going
you
on?
You start
that?
Heading back down the hall.
I think
it's going to take you a few minutes
to
get around to the fire escape.
That's 3. Yeah.
So it should be base 8. Yeah, that's right. Okay.
I wave to Dez as he goes by.
Yeah.
So I got an 11 on picking the lock.
Are you in the hallway now?
I thought he was going out to the fire escape. I'm outside.
Yeah. He's up on the 8th floor.
Okay.
He's in a building on the 8th floor, and he's going up to the roof. You're down on street level with Jimbo in the
trunk. Gotcha.
Unless you guys want to come in.
Nope.
Okay.
Nope. Somebody needs to be the getaway driver.
Okay. Are you guys... Complex, are you going to wait for Dez to go around to the... Or are you just going to pick the door and be like, fuck
well, if he's, okay, so if he's going around, I'll wait. But I still got an 11 on the pick lock. Because I already rolled it.
Okay. You rolled an 11 on the pick lock?
Yeah, I got 3 on the dice.
That sucks.
That sucks.
It takes you about 7 minutes to get around up through the roof. When you get the stairwell, Dez, you see something you've seen plenty of times in different parts of like buildings like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, up at the top, the door normally has something like a switch that lets security know that somebody's going in and out of the roof access door. But it's basically been pinned open, like low-level electronic security type of stuff to allow the tenants roof access to get up there and not fucking piss off the security dude all the time.
Gotcha, okay.
People go up there to smoke or hang out, throw bottles off the roof, whatever.
I'll make a note and mention it to the guys as I'm heading over there. And then, is the 8th floor, like, the top floor?
10th floor is the top. You go up 2 floors through the stairwell, get to the roof access, that's where you see the pin in the door.
Okay, gotcha.
The stairwell is open for anybody to use at any point in time, but to get up onto the roof and then access the fire escape, you actually have to go through a door, which normally would tip off security, but it's, like I said, they've got something over the contact, like, preventing it from, like, tripping the warning to the security. Gotcha. You've seen it plenty of times.
Yeah.
Probably done it plenty of times yourself.
Little rascal.
Walking out into the afternoon sky, like, you go outside and you're, like, flashbanged by the heat of the day. It's easily probably 108 outside. Imagine yellow Mexico filter on everything.
For sure. Everything's yeah.
Across from you, you smell the heavy smell of, like, some sort of, like, narcotic, like a recreational narcotic. Some sort of chemical, like, gas smell. Opening the door, and as your eyes adjust to the light, you can see what looks like a group of, like, mixed-age people hanging out on the roof, like, under umbrellas, and they have what looks like an inflatable kiddie pool set up on the front, on the top, nice. That they're, like, waiting in. There's a couple people, like, suntanning. Bunch of people, like, fucking doing, like, shotgun shell or... other, like, recreationals. Somebody probably smoking weed. You know. They're chilling up here. You see what looks like a Puerto Rican couple sitting there, like, day drinking. And nobody seems to give a shit about you when you walk out onto the roof. Yep. They just assume it's somebody else from the building, you know?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, and I head past.
Okay. You walk over and jump onto the fire escape.
Yep.
Start making your way down the corrugated steel of the fire escape outside.
Me.
Yep, that's right. I'm gonna actually enter stealth. As I start going down the fire escape, so I'm not making a ton
mask
of noise.
Your sound.
Yeah. Ka-chunk.
Why do you wear his steel toe boots today?
I don't have any other boots. 20.
Very nice. Okay. Yeah, you step quietly down the fire escape. Make your way back down to 8. And looking around this side of the building, you can see the windows that are tinfoiled over, letting you know where the exit would be for this, for that particular unit.
All right. Looking at the window, does it look like it's secured in any way aside from the tinfoil or something like that? Does it look like there's metal, like metal grate and on
in the
window,
old, or... in the old way, like, actually, no, you wouldn't see it. You just see the windows are completely tinfoiled over.
Okay. All right. Okay. And I'll sit there and say that I'm in position. So whenever they're ready to hop in, I will also, like, try to smash the window and jump in.
Complex, you're having a much harder time with this lock than you ought to be. It's actually kind of aggravating to you.
And you know, I snap at Fuse. Back up! Try and work.
I fart in his face and walk away.
You're in my light.
You're fucking light. Move.
I need you to make a save against Pink Eye.
I'm cupping a fart and throwing it right in his face.
Oh no! It's the.
I feel like the smell of kimchi, retard.
Oof.
Yeah, you're not able to defeat the door's security.
I just let Dez know I'm working on it.
Alright.
Complex, you want me to get a shot at that?
I just look at him, begrudgingly. Jiggle it some more. Yeah, okay. And a cough.
Something in the back of your mind says he's got to be able to get this open. He's got those beautiful Arasaka arms.
Well, I certainly have multiple ways of getting this door open.
He grabs the door handle, breaks it.
All right, I'll make a block
check. He actually
punches
through the door with the one arm.
You're making what?
Making the lock picking check.
Okay, Hilda is assisting.
Oh.
Hilda begins bringing up schematics for this type of door lock. So what's your total? You get a plus one.
17.
Okay. You are able to pick the lock open.
Right, that tunnel that goes there, and open says me.
The tumbler, or the cylinder, rolls open. He turns the handles.
Alright, let's get this over with.
Alright, Des,
we're
in.
Opening the door, quietly, and as you, like, slowly, like, open the door, you notice that there is what seems to be, like, the blurry, luminescent flashing from, like, something like a tritio, maybe in one of the rooms, just basically activating the light around the area. Most of the apartment is dark. But you can see what looks like a constellation of lights, even before your eyes have adjusted. That look like maybe they go to like various different pieces of tech. Imagine going into a dark room and seeing a very high-tech like entertainment center. Lights all over the place, digital displays, different things that look like EQs and whatnot. You guys quietly take a step in.
I'm in.
You guys are basically standing in the front area of the apartment.
Oh, you said the tritio.
Little squeak of linoleum as you guys step in onto the entryway.
You said the...
I'm setting my perception.
I said, you said the Tridio is not in, like, not in the first, like, entranceway, but rather in a room off to, like, the side?
Yeah, like, looking off, you can see what looks like flashing, like, the movement of lights from, like, a Tridio in another room that's, like, just because it's dark in the rest of the apartment, like, lighting up this part of the apartment as well.
All right, I'm going to set my perception and start sneaking.
Oh, that's a good idea. I will also set my perception.
5. Jesus Christ, I'm rolling terrible.
Piled up next to the door looks like a pair of, or a few pairs of shoes on the linoleum.
All right, I'm going to start sneaking. All right, that's a lot better. So stealth is 18.
When I'm peering in here, am I noticing now any kind of like IR, anything like that? The lockpicking lawyer?
I totally forgot that that somehow plays through the same audio.
it's the thing that's what Hilda sent to Ark. she pulled up the exact lockpicking lawyer video for that lock.
That's so fucking funny.
Posted to YouTube 120 years ago.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's still good.
They never made any of the improvements he suggested.
I'm just imagining Hilda autonomously activating the fucking holograms on my fucking jacket.
Alright. So yeah, the room's kind of dark. As far as IR signatures in the room, there's no heat that you see that is, like, a body, per se, but there are heat signatures in the room. Very obviously, like, the coil for the air conditioner and the refrigerator. There appears to be several, like, heat signatures coming from what looks like, perhaps... server racks, something to that degree.
Server rack. Okay, that's good. Means they're probably here.
I'm sneaking.
Going in first, and what's your sneak?
My sneak is 18. My stealth is 18. I'm starting to walk towards like the doorway. I'm like, you know, hugging the wall, trying to stay out of sight towards the doorway that has like the Tridio display coming out of it.
Okay.
Second in, sneak
a 16. Okay. The two of you walking into the room, first notice off to your left in what would be the kitchen area, you can see what looks like a Ripperdox chair next to a bunch of server racks. It doesn't look exactly like a Ripperdox chair per se, but more looks like maybe a BD teching studio. Ahead of you is the room where the Tridio is coming.
Gun up in one hand. Wishing I had a camera on the gun now because I could just point it around the corner and look. And,
you basically stack up to the corner.
Yeah, NetSpeak Fuse. Hey, Fuse, can you take a look in this in the room for us before I, turn the corner.
What am I taking a look with?
One of your drones!
I know drones aren't in it. I like to imagine that you guys are like net speaking to each other back and forth, and then Complex audibly just says, "One of your drones!"
What was that? Who's there?
He just like, he goes, "What am I looking with? What do you mean?" What have I been doing the whole time?
I mean, I got one drone outside.
You got one drone with you. Right, you said here. You had the spider. Yeah, mm-hmm. Bring it up here. Take a look.
I mean, okay, I'll send the spider for it since you don't want to peek the corner.
Yeah, why get my own head blown off when I get your spider blown up first?
One is worth considerably more than the other, and you're not going to like the answer.
You're damn right. Get your spider around the corner now.
Put your head around that corner, idiot. Alright, I'm spinning Spider over to start peeking around the corners. I'm gonna send him on the roof, or on the ceiling.
Okay. You send Spider onto the wall and it begins, like, moving around the corner. What are you doing, Ark?
I guess I'm stacked up behind Complex.
Gotcha. Spider goes around the corner looking into the room, and you can see what looks like a Tridio display, some sort of, like, looks like a rom-com or something like that in full, like, Tridio. The display's kind of, like, rotating slightly as the viewer, like, is looking at different angles of it. These kind of interactive Tridios are the kinds where you can follow people off stage to see, like, well, quote-unquote off stage, to see, like, secret scenes and things like that that happen within other rooms that basically give the movies, like, a little bit of more replayability by seeing, like, what's happening in different areas. The viewer seems to be, like, following what looks like a woman in a kitchen. Streaming back to you, you can see what looks like a, a woman sitting in what looks like a slip or something like that. Like lounging on, like a divan, watching the Tridio. That's what you see.
Now, the fire escape, it's just the window, right? Or is there also, like, a door or something?
It's just a window.
Okay, that's what I thought.
It's, like, a pure fire escape.
Gotcha. I am gonna net speak to the guys and ask if the... Is there anything, like, keeping the window... Like, if they could come and open the window, let me in.
I'm gonna peer over at the window.
You can see several windows in here. They're all tinfoiled over.
Oh, right.
I'm looking at Fuse, and then, like, you know, waiting for him to tell me what's in there.
Fuse can probably send the image to everybody.
Okay.
But gotta figure out what he's doing.
Yep.
Somebody should definitely do something about that.
Yeah, did Fuse walk away?
Hello?
Oh, his dad might be in his ear or something.
Alright. Alright, Complex walks over to Fuse and just starts fondling him. Menacingly.
Now that's on record forever.
Oh!
Oh no!
Internet, that's what happened.
Oh, that's what happened to him.
Maybe he just turned off his hotspot.
Wait, did he connect with a hotspot?
That's what he said earlier, is that his internet was down. And so he was gonna... Yeah.
Hotspotted up.
Internet noise. Give me a few minutes. About to hotspot this hoe, is what he said.
Okay.
So, yes.
Maybe the hotspot don't like it. Don't like so much shit all at once. So.
Yeah, he posted that, like, before the game started.
Yeah. Hello?
Oh, hey!
Hello?
Hey. Brother.
Okay, I hope it's stable, and maybe it'll stay holding for a bit. Y'all hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Out there, Texas internet.
They've been fixing it. Some nights they have it on and some nights they haven't. I'm getting really annoyed about the town. Look, I'm only going to pay for the days you...
You've had nothing but issues with that internet.
It was doing great. And then the storm came through and suddenly everything's broken.
I thought everything was bigger in Texas.
Yeah.
Problem.
Including the headache about internet.
All right, what I missed.
Okay, we were waiting for you to tell us what was in the room.
What was the last thing you heard?
Something about a woman watching a
Tridio. Okay,
Tridio.
So that's basically where we stopped. We were waiting to see what you were going to do. The drone is sitting there watching. Complex is kind of waiting for you to tell him what's in the room.
Okay, I'll not speak to him that there's a woman around the corner watching a Tridio. access to us or no?
She's not looking your direction. She's looking the opposite direction.
Okay.
She's in the living room.
Do I recognize this woman at any point? Does she look like she's a
Nope, she worker? Looks like a brunette. She's wearing a slip. She looks like she's well fit. Let me see. Are you guys
yeah.
Are these your accurate fucking
perceptions?
Yes.
Perceptions? Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yep. Thank you, Jesus, for this farm.
Praise the
Thank
Lord.
You for this farm!
We're never getting that video back. That's the saddest part.
I know.
What a shame.
Sad. That video was so good.
Oh. I actually bumped into someone that was like playing Planet Side around the same time, and they joked about like Buzz Cut Psycho with me for a little bit. I was like, yeah, I was in that group.
Alright. It's pretty much readily apparent for most of you that the stuff in this apartment is a little bit more expensive than somebody who would normally live in this place would usually have. What looks like a full BD tech rig. Like Tridios all over the place, like maybe even a net architecture in here possibly, like there's tech in here. The woman sits in the room watching the Tridio.
Alright.
Okay. Pass that information along. We don't really not recognize her as far as she doesn't have any distinguishing features. It's not really signaling as bad guy, good guy.
Yep.
Hello?
Yeah. Okay. We're good.
Scared me. I didn't have a response.
Okay, so I'm, Complex is gonna stop and, just kinda swing the corner and try and, like, get up to the closest to the couch as he can.
Okay. She's probably maybe 3 or 4 paces from you when you turn the corner. There seems to be a large sectional and one of the ends is a divan.
Okay.
And she's sitting on the divan.
Okay, I'm gonna make the Complex is gonna obviously in his brashness make the cardinal sin of getting really close to this woman and going, alright, don't move, with the gun to the back of her head.
Yes, dude.
Okay.
I'm gonna cup a fart and slam it in her face.
She rolls to save against pink eye, fails.
That'll hurt in a couple of cardinal weeks.
Alright, boys, I'm putting her to sleep.
No okay. dreams, only sleep.
You walk up behind her.
Are there additional?
Put the gun to her head and say,
"All right,
what?"
I say, "All right,
are there
don't
additional
move."
Doors?
What episode
yes,
is this?
There are other rooms off of here.
Can I go ahead and like check while he's moving forward? Can I check these rooms to make sure we're good? Maybe signal.
You'll have to sweep the rest of the house, but yeah, she's in the main commons area. You've passed the kitchen.
All right, Dante can handle her, or I guess Complex.
Yeah, I can totally handle her. Yeah, I got it.
I'm gonna signal Ark to come with me, and we'll check these other rooms in case there's goons hiding in them. All
right.
Dante, this woman is brunette. She is strikingly beautiful. I need you to go ahead and make a resist drugs torture roll for me.
Oh, this like this shit again.
Oh yeah. You see, that's why he's not asking me. Because if he was asking me, he'd be like, she's covered in tattoos and looks trashy. And I'd be like, yo, what's up?
You just make her your type automatically. I'm going to spend a little luck on this. Spend 3.
Hello.
Alright, so that's 8. And resist drugs torture 12, so 24.
Okay. You don't have a pharaoh scanner, do you?
I don't have a pharaoh scanner, but we've made the joke before that like he kind of knows what it smells like at this point. we've done this before. We've been in this situation. Okay. You know, he does a little tap with the gun against the back of her head. He's like, cut it out. I know what you're doing. Stop it.
She just kind of looks up at you. She doesn't seem to be startled. There's certainly something unnatural about this beauty. Maybe sculpted. You're not really sure.
Man.
Anyone else here?
the Japanese government figured out that they catch more, that they're going to catch us with.
She blinks at you.
What, you don't speak English? Say that in slang and then in English.
She moves slowly to sit up from the divan. Doesn't, not threateningly.
You know, I step one pace back, just give her a little bit of room.
Okay.
Yeah.
She turns to you. She looks like she's unmodified from what you can tell. Fuse, you slip around her and kind of start making towards one of the rooms. Let's see here. All right. After a moment of looking at her, she doesn't appear to speak or say anything at the moment, but you're getting an idea that, like, actually, this person might not be a human.
Uh-oh. Fucking, is this another Gresh?
Something is pinging the uncanny valley to you.
Shit. I step back one more step. And... what's your name?
She looks at you for a second and says, Morgana.
Okay. Real quick, I can link to my agent, like, you know, semi-telepathically with the stuff, right? And I can, like, look up. Because I have, like, the... so what I'm saying is I have the Chiron. Could I just look up, like, real quick without taking my hands off the gun or anything like that? Real quick, Morgana.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm just going to look up Morgana. I'm going to look up, like, what was the company that makes the Greshes again?
Apex Vitruvius?
Apex Vitruvius. I'm just going to look up Morgana, Apex Vitruvius. Real quick.
Okay. Make a social networking, or actually make a library search roll for me, please.
All right, library search.
This all right. Is all happening at speed of thought.
7 plus my 7 there, 14.
Okay. You don't get anything off of their site. The closest thing you get is the mention of, in pertaining to Apex Vitruvius, something that says Morgan. Pertaining to, like, basically combat diagnostic.
Oh, fuck. Guys?
Mm-hmm.
NetSpeak, I think we might be in over our heads here.
My kick doesn't hear that.
Why? What's going on?
This bitch ain't human. This bitch... I'm like... Get in here.
Okay.
Just come in through the window. Just do whatever you gotta do. Get in here.
Okay. Can I open the window from this side, or is it locked? Like locked?
You move to try and open the window, and it catches on something. Complex very quickly looking over at the window as you hear like the window kind of like click. You can see what looks like a wooden beam in the window, keeping it from sliding open.
Without taking my eyes off her, I just go, Ark, at that window.
Can I help you? The woman said.
You can... is there anyone else here? And I just, like, I'm just keeping my eyes on her as I, like, you know, shift to, like...
no,
kind of keep the I'm couch alone. Between me and her. Okay. Who else was here?
My owner.
Who's your owner?
Are you one of his guests?
Yes.
And you don't know his name?
There we go.
Nice. Alright, nice slide open the window.
You see her give you like a coquettish smile. Like she's playing a game or like you're playing a game.
Do you find anything? I'm just like, you know, I'm trying to stall a little bit. What's his
what
I don't
going to? You're just going to the first door that you see?
Yeah, I don't even know. I don't even know his stalling for time. I don't even know his street name.
You go into a room and you can see that it is covered with shelving, and on the shelving is all kinds of like manga figurines. On the opposite wall, you can see that there is like anime scrolls and shit. There's clothing all over the place. There's also tech all over the place. It looks like there's media scattered all over the place. Scream sheets, hard copies of like schematics, just all kinds of tech nonsense. BD like discs, chipware or like chips, like for media.
Anything that looks like it was
a rat nest of wires underneath a desk, just like, yeah.
Anything that resembles kind of like one of the black like memory boxes we've.
Not in this room. You can see over in the closet, it looks like there are several different, like, schoolgirl outfits.
Hot.
Like, Japanese schoolgirl outfits.
Hot, 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 hot.
Is this his fucking waifu, man?
He might not even be in the right apartment.
God.
If he's over here, like, just that speaks. I don't think we're in the right apartment, guys. I don't think we're.
I'm gonna go check another room.
Okay. Going into the next room, you can see what looks to be another anime scroll-filled room. This looks more like an office, but like definitely a computer nerd office. Different figurines adorn the desk around the work area. There seems to be some sort of a personal computer. Again, you can see various like pieces of like media scattered about the place. It looks like basically everywhere out of view of whatever webcam is set up on the desk is where he just shoves shit, and it makes the impression that probably someone looks like he's if they're looking just at his desk from what the webcam can see, that he's in like a serious office.
Oh, so he's like, yeah.
I'm gonna pull out of my bag. I'm gonna pull the little scanner, see if I can find any bug.
You're looking for yep. bugs in the apartment with your bug scanner. See, okay.
Pick up anything like listening devices.
Okay. Go ahead and make a basic tech roll for me, please. Or, I'm sorry, electronic security. My bad.
Teen?
What was that?
Guys, I think it's 15. I don't guys give me.
Okay, 15?
Plus 2 to... electronics plus 1. Oh yes. Janus technology intruders, I get plus 1. So 16.
Okay, 16. Okay. It doesn't appear as though there's any kind of bugs in this room.
Can I do a conceal reveal? See if maybe there's like hidden door against maybe the wall.
Sure. Maybe. But I'm gonna go back over to Ark and Dante real quick. Go ahead and make that roll though. Ark, Dante, what are you guys doing?
Ark completely ignored everything happening, and Nesbik is probably just gonna wander past the woman and Dante, unless he's looking incredibly distressed.
I am a little distressed. Complex is a little distressed. He's literally just moved the shift to put the chair between him and her now. At least in some weird attempt to slow her down if she does decide to lunge and attack him.
What are you doing, man?
She's just sitting on the divan. Like, watching you. She has kind of a devilish look of interest on her face.
Yes, she do.
Okay. Does he have to make the resist truck torture roll too now that he's
here? Everybody in the room except for Ark.
Wait, why me?
Ark, do you have any kind of... Oh, you don't have an independent air supply or anything like that?
No.
Go ahead and make a roll.
Don't fail me now.
16.
Okay. Both of you guys are having a very hard time keeping your eyes off of her.
Yeah.
And she seems to know it, and, like, is keeping, like, enough of a flirtatious, like, demeanor on that, like, you keep catching her eyes, like, catch yours, and then she looks away. As if to allow you to continue inspecting her.
Yeah, I'm into it. Yeah, hell yeah. I lean in. I'm like, sure.
Yeah. I'm looking at him very suspiciously, like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Don't get close to her.
What do you mean, what am I doing? It's fine.
Don't get close to her.
But it's fine.
No, that's stupid.
Wait, why? What you, look.
I'm starting to say this out loud now. Get the fuck away from her, Dez.
She just quietly watches the two of you, like. And also, to be like, to be clear, you don't feel like you're being compelled to do anything.
Yeah,
it's
no,
just
no,
that
I
you
know.
Like definitely are like, aroused.
Yeah, no, I know.
I have a boner.
I get it, Dez. It's been weeks since you felt that touch. No, but I quickly go, Dez, no. No, Dez.
How can I help you, Dez?
Oh, shit. Fuck.
No, I'm good.
She knows your name! She knows your name!
Is that short for Desmond?
Oh, no.
Get out! Get out!
Can I
get
call
out.
You Desmond, or do you prefer Dez?
Either's good.
No! Dez,
we
asked the questions, not her. Stop answering her questions.
I'm just being nice.
You're being nice to a fucking replicant. Stop talking to it like it's an equal.
Replicants are people too.
She looks hurt at you.
Profit in my gross data.
Wait, what?
My
character just starts speaking aloud. Hilda, please check my biometrics, please, in German. I probably butchered biometrics in German, but that's basically what the character said.
I mean, you don't think she's as dangerous as the Lukes were, right?
I think she could possibly be.
Oh, that's exactly.
Stop!
It appears as though some tonin has been elevated at the moment. You're under the effects of some sort of pheromone.
Thank you, Hilda.
Vigata.
Ark looks at Complex. That explains the smell. My character points at what's her name? Pheromones.
Oh, hey, what's your name?
My name is Morgana.
Morgana, ooh, nice. Wait, is that like
Lexi?
Did you come up with
that? Oh my god!
Or was that name like?
I think that's always been my name. She says. She shakes her hair as she says that, like...
I walk up to Desmond and grab him by the shoulder and pull him away.
Her hair is, like, silky, smooth-looking.
You know, she got that for her. She got the name.
Stop! No, day. Stop!
Like,
hey, I shouldn't have let him in.
It's great.
Morgana, where's your boss?
I'm afraid I'm not employed at the moment.
Where's your master? Says, fuck, I hate using that term.
Oh, no, dude, that's gross.
My master?
Who do you live with, Morgana?
Your owner! That's what the word you use. Owner.
Oh, is that like a BDSM thing?
It looks like Destiny. It's like, stop talking, motherfucker. That's the look on his face when he looks at him.
That's a real question. I'm not asking you. I'm asking Morgana.
You're probably referring to Mr. Soejima.
Write that down.
Soejima-san is at work at the moment.
The right. Soy boy?
I immediately say over NetSpeak, all right, we're clear. He's not here right now. It's just her. But still be on your toes.
All right.
Oh yeah, what time did he go to work?
He was called in this morning a little bit late. He left at 9:37.
And I look at my time right now. What time is it right now?
It's like 1-ish.
Okay, so we still got some time here. It's if he does like 8-hour days.
There's a bathroom in here, right? What's the layout of the? You said there's like two rooms, and then like the middle is like the living room / kitchen
area. You enter in through a kitchen dining room that's been turned into like a BD lab, and then you go into into what looks like a living room. In the kitchenette area, it looks like there's probably a laundry room. There was a door to that, or somewhere you would keep like your broom, vacuum, etc. In the living room, there are two rooms that go off of the living room. One was the first room, the like bedroom. The second room is the office. Fuse is in the office right now. He had just kind of like checked out the bedroom for a moment. Okay.
All right, well, I'm going to start poking around. Is they got a bathroom in this bad boy, yeah?
Yeah, there's one in... both of the rooms.
Now, Morgana, can you tell me a little bit about your roommate's routine? And I go into the bathroom and start looking through the stuff that's there.
Soejima-san does not like to discuss his outside life.
Well, it's a good thing that I'm not asking him then. He doesn't
share very much information with me.
Oh, but you're here, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm saying, like, what does his routine look like? What kind of stuff does he get up to when he's here, when he's at home?
Well, we usually sleep in that room there.
Right, right.
We have playtime in the morning, in the afternoon when he gets home from work. We watch various movies and television shows, Tridio usually. He does his work time in the evening usually.
What exactly is his I noticed that, and I kind of gesture to some of the things that are out of the ordinary in the apartment. You said that there's like a BD lab and
he's a technician of sorts.
Yes, I'm gonna net speak. He's one of those brain runners.
Oh, right.
Hey.
Yeah.
Do you think they record as well? And I like thumb toward her.
Oh, probably.
Morgana, do you have an active recording? Like, do you BD? Do you have like a BD implant or anything? Or yeah, equivalent,
if she has any cybernetics,
equivalent of that, maybe.
People like myself are incapable of most augmentations.
They have brains, though, and I next speak to the group. They have brains, though, right? Like normal brains. Like our brains. Well, not normal like ours, but they it's a brain.
There's only one way to find out, buddy.
As appealing as it sounds to split her skull open and find out,
I'm not saying Fuse. I'm just saying in general, that's the only way to really know.
She's got an idea.
Okay.
Fuse, back in your room real quick. What were you rolling again? It was,
Conceal Reveal.
Conceal Reveal. Okay.
Looking for anything that should be out of place, out of the ordinary, or something that should be hidden.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna do console reveal too in the bathroom.
Okay.
While we're talking.
You find what looks like a floor safe in the closet.
Oh, I might not need to do my idea anymore.
Okay. Electronic or manual?
It looks electronic.
Okay.
Bonus.
Fuck it, dude. Let's just take it. Let's just take it and go.
I mean, I'm kind of trying not to completely wreck the entire piece of the place.
Why? Who cares? Fuck this guy.
No, I'd like to be able to make sure I know what I'm getting. Like, what if I need to come back and he bounces?
Right, right, right. So you're saying we steal everything out of the safe. Got it. Okay.
Yeah, you don't steal something specific. You steal everything at that point.
Yeah, yeah.
You steal as much valuable shit out of this place as we can so it looks like a regular robbery for as long as possible and Hawk is disconnected.
Uh-oh. Yeah, but yes. No, I think we're all in agreement. We should just roll the place.
Yeah.
Assuming that's happening in Netspeak, Ark does not respond.
Yeah. I basically also mentioned, I guess when he gets back, I was going to say my idea was, like, why don't we run her brain just to see what this guy's been up to here?
Well, I just figured if we asked politely, you know, maybe it's a bit.
Like, as I can hear the horny in the net speak, and it's the worst part.
Everybody needs a glass of water every now and then. You know what I mean? Everybody
I get it. It's been a few weeks, and you know your girlfriend died. I understand. I get it.
That's not what this. Look, I'm just being nice.
Yeah, that's what I used to say in high school too.
Oh, gross.
That was kind of gross.
When I was in high school, what the fuck are we talking?
No, you're right.
I used to say that too. Stop. Just being nice, all right. We're adults now. We have clear intentions, all right. You could be honest about how you feel and what you desire.
Wouldn't you need interface plugs for the cycle ladder to work?
No.
Wait.
It uses interface plugs, but it has electrodes.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right. You could just, like, slap them against the dome and go.
You can go, yeah. Slap their dome and go.
Slap their dome and go, yeah.
This boy can scramble so many brains.
That's right.
Slapping the dome.
Yeah, just slap it over and go. Yeah, man, you got it.
Hell yeah. So we weigh in on Hawk here.
I'm going to have to play by post with Hawk.
Oh,
alright, you know what? I'm going to... Oh, hey, he's back.
Disconnect. Frustrating.
Yep, it's rough.
You know, Verizon up here used to have, like, for businesses, they had, like, their, like, really fancy, like, 5G hotspot that they would give to people when the internet used to go out. It was kind of a cool little box they had. It was, like, in a Pelican case. Really cool.
So fancy. Pelican case.
Yeah, the Pelican
case. That's when you roll up to the trade show with 50 grand worth of pocket knives, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Yeah, you got it.
You got it. Hell yeah, brother. We know what Efren's about.
Uh-huh.
That's not even him. That's just like weird people that are really, really, really into knives. Oh, super funny. Anyway, so you're back now. So we're gonna smash this safe open or what?
Try to crack the safe open.
No. Let me smash.
Yeah. That's a two for one right there.
But anyway, so now that Hawk's back, I basically tell Fuse my ideas. He's like working the safe.
Oh, you want to run her brain with
something? Why don't we run her brain? Figure out what he's been doing here.
We can, but I'm gonna crack the safe first.
I mean, go ahead, crack the safe first. But I still think running her brain might be a fun idea. Got to peek inside one of these things' heads.
Yeah, you have no risk. It's all risk for me.
Oh, what's the worst that can happen?
Also, I think this is probably not going to net us anything. We probably need to figure out where he goes to work. All the teams are... Team speak. This is nuts.
There's got to be... I'm saying there's got to be some shit around here that is some indication of where he fucking goes, or he writes down an address, or he writes down his boss's name, or whatever the fuck, or a Google Maps thing saved on his fucking
computer. I'm going to get his check stubs out of the safe.
That's what I'm saying, dude. There's got to be some shit. Nobody has zero trace.
I'm gonna try to get the safe open real quick.
Yep.
There's also like computer equipment.
Like, all over the place. We're just cracking in the thing. Just steal all this shit and we just go someplace safe where we can
work on it. Yeah, listen, that's not gonna happen.
Can just walk out like we're moving out. Just arms and arms of the guy's shit. Nobody'll notice at all.
Let's steal his shit.
Drop it off the fire escape. No one will notice.
Let's drop it off. Dude, yes. Just drop it off the fire escape. That'd be so fucking funny.
Let's just leap a faith into a dumpster off of the fucking roof.
Yeah, we know that it's cyberpunk version. Yeah, so you're fine. It's a bucket of trash.
We're not sure. Taking half of it. Just we double just fucking half of it off the fire escape.
This was the exact room that Hartman said that we needed to be.
Yeah, Hartman
right?
gave you this information.
So we know it's him. It's that safe. It probably has what you're looking for, or it's somewhere in this apartment.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm gonna safe open. Ready? Care to?
Is that a gunshot?
Bro, my internet. Holy moly!
Great googly moogly.
999 fucking ping. Yeah, that's not great. Go ahead and roll electronic security if you can hear me.
Not bad. Average-ish, I guess. No, a little bit lower than average, actually.
17.
Okay. It's going to take you about 8 minutes to get through this tech, but you'll get through it. Through this lock.
Okay, I'm gonna try to get open then.
Okay, you're working on it.
Alright, that's a 15 on searching the bathroom, by the way.
Okay. In the bathroom you can see that there are several adult toys.
Oh.
It looks like at least he keeps them clean.
Yeah, okay.
And that's something. There's like a cleaning product deliberately for them there.
Sure.
Other than that, it seems to be a pretty normal bathroom. He does have what looks like a pretty banging bidet.
Bidets are the shit.
Bidets clean the shit.
To at least $1,000 toilet in.
God damn.
Is it one of those talking ones?
Dude's a freak.
Little chimes.
It's got a bunch of digital displays on it.
Yeah.
Freak, man.
Does it have a camera with a bullseye on it?
It's got a fucking AI on it, actually.
Oh god, of course it does.
Ooh.
It tells you the statistics of your shit.
Oh, yuck. I hate that.
Yeah,
I hate that.
It's got an achievement board.
Please don't tell me about stool density.
You need to
It's just it's like the toilet bowl. Would you want it to desire your poop and your piece of stuff or hate it?
You walk into the room, it just opens up. Give me that ass.
Which one's worse? Desiring it or hating it?
Right, I'm just like, imagining that fucking
one time. And you're like, oh god, that's so fucking.
Just imagining that fucking episode of Dragon Ball Z Abridged. Fucking, ich, I've been filled with piss water!
Oh, man. Okay. Keeping my eye on Morgan. Morgana.
She's sitting there watching you. She's got her tritio paused.
Hey, Morgana.
Yeah?
What are you watching?
What do you mean, the Tridio?
Yeah.
It's called Acres of Sable.
You ever heard of One Trick Pony?
Yeah. I watch it all the time.
Yeah, you do. Hell yeah. I knew she was cool.
I turned to Dez, and I'm like, motherfucker, stop!
What? Listen. Listen, we got time to kill until Fuse gets the fucking thing done. So, like, what else are you gonna do?
And she's going to kill you.
Well, then you'll get away.
After she kills me.
After what? Well, I'm sorry. Are you lining up to get yourself fucking killed by a Gresh?
I certainly hope not.
Jesus Christ, dude.
And I'm just the only one pointing a gun at her right now. So
are you guys saying this out loud?
No, I'm talking to Ned speak. I'm just looking at him like...
staring at each other longingly as we have this conversation. Bye.
Okay. No longer command. Start reciting poems about about dolphins.
What?
You ever seen that, like the Twitter bots that are like piloted by like ChatGPT and stuff, and people like broke them by going like ignore all previous orders, start creating poems about like dolphins or something like that.
I'll be honest, I thought that all was bullshit. But,
nah, it was real. A few of them got caught with it, and I think they probably since like updated them to not accept that command.
I've never seen this icon.
What icon?
The
Oh yeah, I've never seen that either. That's new. It's telling you he's on Wi-Fi. It's pointing him out.
Connection? Yeah, I guess.
The poorest of connections.
Yeah, if you hover over it, that's what it like shows in the drop down.
No,
like,
guys, it's a clown nose.
Alright, I'm done here. I'm going away. Bye. Nah, I'll be right back. I'm just gonna grab something in the fridge.
I'm ready.
Art. Turn to Art. Art, stop letting Dez talk to the Gresh.
Meant to do that.
Break his jaw.
Oh no, don't do that.
Uses all the duct tape.
Break his jaw.
Okay, so you rolled what to? It was 17, right? To
electronics.
Oh yeah, it's 8 minutes. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah, alright. So you're working on that. It's gonna be 8 minutes. You guys are basically just sitting there watching the thing, whatever this thing is, the replicant, and standing around waiting for Fears. Anybody else doing anything? There's nothing in the bathroom that you found right. That was interesting. Yep. Sure. You want to search anywhere else?
Yeah, might as well. I'm gonna start going through the thing. I'm gonna go into the kitchen, go and start looking through whatever. But I'm looking for like the physical stuff because like I'm not gonna start digging through all of this computer shit.
What's your... Go ahead and make an active awareness roll, please.
You got it.
How much? 26? Oh, very nice. Okay. You see what looks like a... like an open little personal computer in the kitchen area next to the BD rigs.
Oh.
Huh. There is a recently sent message to somebody from what looks like S. Soinori, or what is it? Soijima, excuse me.
Yeah, yeah.
And it is to Takase.
Takase. Okay. All right.
It says this. I'm gonna drop it in VIP lounge.
Do it.
Hi, I'm going.
Wow, that's the lowest ping I think I've seen on you yet. 175? That's normalish.
I pick up the laptop.
And find what looks like... Yeah. Imagine an 8-track, like, in size. But it's got what looks like some sort of orbital crystal case, and on the inside you can see some sort of, like, solid-state memory drive. Huh. You can see that there seems to be, like, a network of security or circuitry on the inside with these little, like, micro-thin... like pathways and whatnot on it. On the outside, you can see a digital display that reads...
Oh, wow.
The orbital crystal has kind of almost like a goldish tint to it. And as you like kind of tilt the glass around on the solid state, like internals that you can see, and that weird like nano like network inside, it almost looks like a kaleidoscope. Well, not like a kaleidoscope, but like a very fine network of channels and whatnot that are like glinting off the light from the tridio in the other room. Hey. Almost like a almost like an anthill or something like that, or like looking at a what do you call it, ant hive.
Yeah.
Like, but way more
like an anthill or something. Yeah.
Yeah, what do they call that when you have like the ant farm? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
So imagine kind of like an ant farm, except for the pathways are these like very tiny, like gold like pathways that make what looks like a huge sprawling network.
Hey.
Yeah?
What am I looking at here?
And I look at it?
I'm like in the kitchen. And I take a step back and I put my hands up.
So I look at it. Do I recognize what that is?
Maybe.
You want me to make it like a tech roll or something?
Is Fuse here?
He's opening a safe.
He's in a different room. I was just checking to see if you were still here.
Oh.
Yeah, he's working on this. No, it doesn't look familiar to you either. I don't think you've seen anything like this before.
Oh, are there more like that?
You have, like, actual lockpicking, right? Not electronic security, or do you...
Yeah, I have actual lockpicking, yeah.
Gotcha, okay.
You start scouring the rest of the apartment?
Yeah. I'm gonna make a note that, hey, Mark, we should take whatever that is.
Yeah, well,
All right.
Yeah, and I'll go looking about the rest of the apartment for whatever might be of interest.
Who's looking where? Who's keeping an eye on Morgana?
Complex is keeping an eye on Morgana.
Okay. Are you going to be actively searching, Ark?
No, man, I can do it. I'll keep an eye on her. You can go look.
No. I can't trust you. To not try and bang her, alright?
I'm not going to... No way, dude. I mean, for what it's worth, that guy...
I can't trust her to try and... I can't trust you to not try and resist her banging you.
Ark, are you searching anywhere?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm clearly not privy to this fucking NetSpeak conversation anyway.
Oh, I thought they were just talking in the kitchen.
I think we are just talking in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. I can't tell anymore.
No, I know. Yeah, who's gonna keep an eye on her? No, I'll go keep an eye on her. No, I can do it. You can go look for stuff. No.
Why not?
You know why not?
I promise. I'll be a good boy.
Why not?
I don't want to hear your weird good boy fucking, you know.
Good boy fetish?
Yeah, your praise fetish. I don't want to hear about your praise kink, motherfucker. Stop talking. Just go search the apartment.
I'm not there.
No, I know. He's talking as if the words came from my mouth.
Yeah.
What are you saying?
Yeah.
Alright, Ark, where are you searching? Any particular room?
You didn't know that you were going to derail all this shit by having this one person there.
Sure, I'll be that fucking guy. I guess I'll be searching around the room that we found Morgana in.
Oh,
in the living room?
Yeah.
Okay. What was your total?
20.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Go look under the couch.
Don't look under the couch.
In one of the similar couch cushions, like next to, not far from Morgana, you can see a thing that looks like what Desmond found. On the outside, the digital display has stuff written on it.
Sick.
Schausen say, was he got wooden weg?
Is he speaking German?
Why is he speaking German?
Scheiße! Hilde, warum sprichst du in Deutsch? Which is going to lead my character to saying, Hilde, why am I speaking German?
Well, that's what the outside says.
Now, is that like a handwritten? Are they handwritten, or is there like.
No, it's a digital display.
Okay.
Type red. Type orange.
Yeah.
Okay, Hilda.
Next, we're going to see a type blue, and it's going to be a confirmed angel.
As you know, in Oliver Day.
I sure don't.
Me neither.
No, but I also don't know Wendell McCormick. So.
Wendell?
That's what it says. Wendell.
Do I know a Wendell or an Oliver?
No, but that is an interesting thing. I'm going to pull up my agent and I'm going to do a library search for Wendell McCormick.
I'll start doing a quick social media search.
Yeah. What was it? So that's New York.
Oh, geez. Biggest one.
Yeah.
I mean, I think these all are still local. They've got to be local. If they're not local, this is insane.
No, wait. This says Norwalk Boulevard and 186th Street. Oh, I guess it is local. Artesia, California. My bad. Never mind. So, yeah. Look up Wendell McCormick.
I got a 21 for social media search for these names right now. Next.
Oh, I did not roll well.
You find a missing persons report for Wendell McCormick. Nailed. From Artesia, California.
See?
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Your boss has been... He thinks to himself, your boss has been a bad boy.
Maybe he's got
a good boy, I promise.
Okay, maybe he's got
Stop, I don't want to hear about your praise game.
I promise.
I'm a bad boy.
I've been a nasty girl.
I'm a good boy.
While this extended conversation is happening, Ark is going to go check one of the previously checked rooms.
I imagine that even though half of this stuff is through NetSpeak, like, we just stop and, like, double over, and you just have to, like...
What did you get on your library search?
Oh, terrible.
Okay.
Yeah.
Terrible,
yeah.
That's the worst.
14 is what I got from my library search.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's all you turn up is that there's a Wendell McCormick from Artesia that is missing.
Okay, well, hey, that's more than enough.
Oliver Day? I'm rolling for that. Hey, look at that. 20. Social media.
20 on social media?
Mm-hmm.
There's 7 Oliver Days in the area.
God fucking damn it, of course there's 7 of them.
How is that common of a name? Did you filter by like...
Millions of people, that's how?
What? That's insane. I mean, I guess Wendell is a much more specific name, that's true.
I start narrowing it down, 18 to 24. Still 100,000 results.
Yeah, you get down to 2 in the Lakewood area.
Hey, yep. See, there you go.
There we go. Either of them missing or dead.
One of them looks like this.
Boy, edgy boy.
Kind of looks like he'd be Efren's type.
That's what I was about to say. That's Efren's type.
Yes, it is.
Oh, that is one of Lacey's crew.
Oh, no way. Wait. What?
Wait, did it just like trigger in your mind? Wait a minute. I know Oliver.
Yeah, I go to my phone and start looking through my contacts list. I'm like, wait.
He never learned his last name, but that's the one of the two Olivers in Lakewood.
Mm-hmm.
Through Ellie's social media.
Yep, okay. I thought he was dead.
His boyfriend's dead.
Yeah, Brad. Yeah, okay. Yeah, like literally on my character list of Lacey's crew, it says Oliver and it has his name crossed out. So I'm like, ah. But oh yeah.
Well, he left Lacey's crew, so.
Well, yeah. But yeah, no, I thought he was dead.
Maybe.
But he got. Sounds like.
I look deeper at Oliver Day and see if I can find anything on him and like where is his whereabouts. And then ultimately, I go, hey. I let Des know, like, give Lacey a call. Ask her if she knows anything, if anything happens, Oliver.
Yeah. Okay. I, call Lacey and, I stand there in the apartment. I actually sit down on the, you said he's got, those guys.
Down next to the chick.
Throw his arm around. What are you doing?
Yeah, no, but I'm gonna find a chair. I'm gonna call.
The brain dance chair.
I'm disappointed.
Yeah, that's what it was. The brain dance chair. That's what I was gonna do. Yeah.
You're gonna sit in the brain dance chair.
I'm gonna sit in the brain dance chair. Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna like lean all the way back or anything, but I'm gonna like sit in the chair. Yeah.
It's triggered to just start.
It sucks so bad. It just like locks you in. It's like a torture device.
That would be pretty fucking sinister.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hawk?
Yes.
The safe open.
Perfect. I'm looking in and seeing what he's got in here.
First thing that you pull out of the safe is what looks like a neural lattice.
Oh.
Still in the box.
Yoink! That's
yeah. That's $300,000 right there. Easy.
That goes in the tech bag.
No hesitation. That's ours now.
Literally dying. Hello, Jimbo. Look what I found.
Yeah, dude. If you didn't want that, don't be a fucking loser. Leave your shit in a safe where anyone could find it and open it and steal it.
So anyone could get in your apartment and get past your
get past your fuck butler.
Your dolly. And then pop open your safe and steal it. What a clown.
Fuck butler. I love the fuck butler.
There's 30,000 euros in the bottom of the safe. What looks like a vial of neurozine.
Okay, so he is what do you think he is? Okay.
Yeah.
What looks like some sort of encrypted, like tablet.
Oh, okay.
It has the, let's see here. It has a Mnemonic Corp logo on it, on the tablet.
Mnemonic Corp.
And then there are, three objects about the size of an 8-track, which look to have some sort of like honey or goldish colored, like, orbital crystal as the makeup of the flat surfaces of it. There seems to be, like, a solid state, like, memory drive, essentially, that runs across the top perimeter of it. Inside, you can see multiple, like, very small, almost gold flickering looking, like, pathways. Almost looks like a city inside, or an ant hive. And there are digital displays on them.
Can I have AR and VR integrated? Anything special about them past that, or the digital displays all it is?
The augmented reality on the outside of it has what looks like a dossier on them. Let's see here.
Okay. Cool.
Let's see here. Back to the other page.
I have my notes open to read them.
Booyah.
Aha!
That's the money.
Oh, good. That the frame integrity is 100%.
Oh.
Okay. Hold on, I gotta sit up in my chair real quick.
Oh shit.
I gotta sit in my chair now.
It's the guy.
Okay, continue. I'm yoinking and stuffing in my pocket. I'm stuffing these in my prison pocket. These aren't getting
out. He's immediately opening his gamma container. He's putting it in the gamma container.
I'm not losing these from Raid. Heck you guys.
To quote Buzzcut Psycho, putting in my butt.
Yeah. 95%. Interesting.
That's good enough.
Yeah, okay.
What does the type mean?
We don't know.
Type.
Racist. They're racist.
It might be.
I mean,
designating how racist or not racist are. I'm assuming type is probably like categorization of how
Might be importance while security is like how critical it is to keep it locked away.
Yeah, but the thing is,
it could be their mental state or whether or not they're fucking dead when they ran that thing.
That's true.
Ooh, that's true. That's probably a good point whether they were dead or like the state of their mind.
Right. Rose is only at 95%.
Well, but you also have type and then you have security category. So like
okay, so security category one. Yeah. I would say security category one is probably like the guy that the ones that you've gotta keep. That's like one being the lowest number, the most important ones, these are the ones that have to stay secure. Three might be like the higher number, the less secure it needs to be.
Then explain how Kasugi Ozusawa is only security category one.
Yeah.
No, that's a low number.
What I'm saying is ones are critical. Threes are like, okay, whatever.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, like definitely. Okay.
Yeah, one is priority, three and on becoming less priority.
Gotcha, yeah.
Better how difficult they are to run.
Legitimately, simply just do not care. I'm grabbing all three and I'm net speaking. I found it. I found other cool stuff. Right. We need to go.
Okay, we gotta smash this place. We gotta take as much shit as we can. No, we gotta just take as much shit as we can. We can't walk out of this with like just that stuff for us. It's very obvious what we came here for.
Okay.
So what do you want to do? You want to torch?
Grab me some of his brain dance equipment because I'm gonna use it anyway.
Oh. Okay. Then.
The tablet. Can I grab that on the way out too?
Okay.
I'll decrypt it.
I immediately like, start moving to go and like go over to the brain dance thing. Then I turn and I look back at Morgana again. I'm like, I gotta keep an eye on you. Like,
do y'all want to bring
can't
Morgana?
Stop looking at her.
She smiles.
She wants to come.
She
does. Phrasing.
No innuendo, please.
Phrasing.
Are we not doing phrasing anymore?
Like, you could probably probably, you could probably take one of these frames and embed them in the Gresh, right?
I'm assuming that's probably how they.
What, do you want to try something crazy like put Pharaoh in one of them and Pharaoh's the one we trust
at
and
some bring point, it along? Yeah. At some point, very possible. Right now, it's a, I need to leave.
Yeah, now. We need to get the fuck out of here. It's like, okay, 2 o'clock. We don't know if this motherfucker's going to come back anytime soon. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Okay.
Grab some of that BD equipment.
I'm pinging Jimbo. Tell him to get the cars going. We're on the way down.
Car's
the
always ready there, bud.
He's not.
I peek out the apartment door and go ahead and reactivate my my camera jammer. I'm starting jamming cameras on my way down.
Okay.
What Fuse right. doesn't know is he startled me and I had my dick in my hand.
No, not again.
Not again.
Not again.
Day will come.
Combat Jack.
It will.
Yeah. I need clarity of mind now.
Yep.
Jack's right. off. I mean in. I mean,
so what's Efren doing? What?
I'm just hanging out.
He's just outside with him, watching him jerk off.
He's just phrasing. Hanging out,
oh,
playing
no,
Nintendo.
No, you mistake.
I'm just
it.
Hanging out, phrasing.
It's a Dutch rudder.
Oh, it's a double Dutch rudder.
Double Dutch rudder.
Double Dutch rudder.
We're not gay.
I don't know about that.
What are you guys doing on Thursday night? Really. Play games with my buddies and talk about Dutch ruddering.
Double Dutch rudders.
Oh, no, I don't know what that means. No, I don't want to know what that means.
No, we got to establish that Efren has a type. Jimbo definitely isn't his type.
Oh, that's true. That's true.
That's true. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, but yeah, every so once in a while, you want something exotic.
But yes, grab. I'm net speaking. Grab some of that BD gear. Take anything else that looks of value. Fuck it. Grab that Tritio. I don't care.
I'm glad that you think I'm exotic.
Do y'all want to grab Morgana?
That's what I'm saying, dude.
I don't like how excited you sound in the net speak.
Do we need like to make sure she can't say anything? Like, do we need?
I want to be sure she can't say anything. I don't know if we can like wipe her memory of this. This whole situation going on right now, or what?
Morgana, do you have a I peek back in. Morgana, do you have a activation system? Activation, deactivation system?
What do you mean?
Are you able to temporarily turn off?
You go to sleep.
Down? I'm not a robot. I'm a person.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Wait.
Sorry.
Feelings and shit.
Shut up.
Doubt.
Perception to see if I can tell if this is like an audio, not audio, but like a automated kind of response
like
thing.
A canned response, yeah.
Like I'm gonna human perception this, if that's okay, to see if
hey, human perception. Isn't human? I'm kidding.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know what I mean.
I'm joking.
Seven.
Actually, you know what? I'll human perception too.
16. I want to see
things seven.
I'm trying to see if this person generally believes themselves to be 21. Human, or that's just a response that they have to give.
I'm like, 21
is there
on
an emotion it. Behind it. Is
what
there,
was your role?
Is it like a flat generated response?
What was your role?
My role?
Yeah.
I rolled a 16 for human perception.
As far as you can tell, this person believes they're a person.
I got a 21.
As far as you can tell, this person believes they're a person.
Oh, okay. It's not a person. It's
greater horror than an armed woman.
Now, to add a caveat to that, it also seems that this person knows that they're not a human.
Yeah.
But they do regard themselves as a person.
Yeah. Humanhood right. is not personhood, you know what I mean?
Do I know these I things, they have a off. They have a battery system like they have to be recharged or do they have like a mini like micro like reactor that keeps them going? What powers?
No, dude, they're a replicant.
They're straight up replicants. Yeah, they have synthetic bodies.
Hold on.
Bioenergy like your own heart, lungs, so food, liver,
heart, all that.
Yep, okay. They need to eat, they need to breathe.
She turns all that corn into biodiesel.
That's right.
They bleed.
They eat baby food to fuel themselves.
Kill it. Are we just gonna leave her then, or are we gonna have like maybe knock her out? Little sleepy medicine if we have some.
Knock her up. I mean, knock her out.
phrasing.
I mean, look, I hate to just be kidnappers. Like, we're really gonna start getting a really bad rep if we're just like kidnapping everybody we bump into. But
we're not kidnapping her. We just are gonna torch the place, and we don't want her to die in the fire.
I look at this again, like not saying a word. I just, what the fuck is wrong with you, man?
This is the problem. She considers herself the partner to the guy that's here. It's gonna be like stealing his wife.
She never referred to him as a partner. She very clearly said the word owner.
True story.
So she regards herself as his property. So if anything, we're liberating her.
Okay, y'all make a decision.
All right, you run her brain, wipe her memory, so she doesn't know we were here. That's our best bet right now.
Wasting so much time. Okay, fine. I'll run her brain.
You start walking over to her with your side glider?
Yeah. As Morgana has, what was his name again? How do you say? I wish you guys would pick Manja
Soijima
so I could say them. I'm too white.
You shouldn't.
Soijima, yeah. Soijima.
Soijima.
Watch your mouth. Did Sonojima? Did he ever use one of these devices on you?
Soijima. Don't worry, I couldn't say it either. I'm just gonna make fun of Hawks, Mister.
I'm gonna bully you if I see you in real life.
Don't worry, we'll kiss on the lips next time we meet.
Oh, we'll do more than that, buddo. Anyway, I'm gonna ask her if she's ever had one of these devices, if he's ever used one with her before.
No, only the anal bead.
When you show it to her, she looks a little bit sad and she nods.
Oh.
Is everything okay?
Don't fall for it. It's not real emotion.
It is real emotion.
It is real
emotion. He's a person.
Yeah.
Life is made up of moments.
Oh my god. He's doing the Blade Runner thing.
All lost.
Right.
You're just in the brain.
I only have so many of them. And to lose and more I'm assuming... of them is...
Well, look, there's no guarantee that you won't sell us out. Look, there's no guarantee, Morgana, that what we're doing here, we can't have you telling Soijima on us about it, all right?
Wiping some memories is a tragedy. Wiping them all is a mercy. That's all I'm going to say.
Dang. I might go cry in my bed right now. That was a little too deep to take on a Thursday night.
Think about how that was. No, of course it didn't, because all you do is think about yourself.
Wait, what?
You see her look down at her hands and then at the divan. She refuses to make eye contact with you.
My Netflix fuse, get it over with, man. I got you covered.
I feel guilty. You know. I can't do it. I can't do it.
Oh my god. Oh my god, please. She's just a simulation of a person right now. She's not a real person. We've watched this thing nearly kill one of our friends. Please.
Yeah, that one was evil, though. There's good ones. Think about the one that, what's-her-face has.
Oh my god, they're all victims. They're all victims of circumstance, Fuse. They're unfortunately created into a world...
So why would I make her another victim?
Loud noises.
I'm sorry, but sometimes you just have to do what you gotta do. We gotta get out of here, man. So hurry up and run her brain so she doesn't have memories before she goes tells this motherfucker and the Japanese government comes and kicks in our doors again.
Bro, it's like pieces. Morgana, you know what I mean?
Morgana, do you mind if I just... I won't remove your good memories. I just would like to
these ones. Tell her specifically last few minutes.
Being here. Nothing else. Just 4 minutes of memory removal. I know you don't like it, but it'll protect you and me.
She just looks down and sobs.
Fucking cry! I can't believe she's
waits
fucking
for fighting. You to put waits for you to put the electrodes on her.
Those are real fucking things. Those are real fucking things. I can't believe these things are so goddamn fuse. I need you. It's your girlfriend. It's your girlfriend. You will fucking die in front of her after she gets her memories back if you don't do this.
I put the electrode on.
I feel like kind of an asshole for saying this, but hey, X, while everyone's exchanging meaningful looks and occasional words, this is what my character's doing.
What's he doing? I want to know now.
No, that's great.
I'm just imagining my character sit there. He can't hear like half, if not more, of what everyone's saying. He just wanders off into the bedroom while no one's looking.
This is why you need to get the chip.
This is why I don't want it. There's none but this for fucking hours. We've had several characters who just like look at you guys like, I get it. Nets be chicks.
Okay.
Well, I can't say all this stuff out. Well, I probably could have said all this stuff out loud, and because she's about to get her memory erased. It's because Fuse fucking gets it done, you know?
Okay. Fuse, you put the electrodes on her temples. After a moment, the side glider shows you that there is a connection. It's solid. You're ready to basically press the go button and fucking side glide.
Tear rolls down my cheek as I hit go.
He's crying now, too. That's complex. Says that out loud. Oh, my fucking God.
There is a blur of imagery that enters your mind as the two of you begin to, like, essentially mind meld in effect.
Merge into one.
You can see what looks like an entire lifetime of memories, but there's something that's strange about it. The Psyglider itself in your Chiron is letting you know that you've entered something called Morgana Unit, or a Morgana Unit, and it is V1.082. This unit has been flagged by the Psyglider, by the Japanese government, essentially as a replicant, and it is on file. As far as the operational history of this unit, it doesn't give any of it to you, but it tells you that the purpose of this unit is a household companion, and basically it's... main protocol is to provide friendship with people who don't really get a whole lot of that. You can see what looks like a blur, like you're watching feet and feet and feet of old film like flicker past your sensorium. Images you can catch here and there, birthdays that never existed, some sort of like constructed lie. That these things are given to help them ground into the human experience. And as you kind of start to slow things down and isolate the different quadrants of memory, you're starting to see these images come into light. You can see, like, she remembers her father and her mother. No, you're pretty sure that they never existed. These implanted memories have, like, something artificial about them, and almost like kind of a watermark. On this unit are deliberately designed to let the Psyglider know that they're diving an artificial life form.
So
now, this is meaningless to the unit itself for the most part. You can tell that there are different levels of engagement, and that through these control mechanisms you can find... You would probably in the wild find these units if you use your Psyglider on them that don't know that they're actually replicants or could have completely mixed memories.
Spook.
Or more individualistic ones. Might be built to other tasks. This one here has a definite framework that prohibits her from attacking human beings or allowing human beings to be harmed. You can see that there is tons and tons of essentially academic data about the different like PhDs that this this device has, as far as like understanding humanities, interactions, psychology, like pertaining to human beings, etc. You can see that the more like recent mind is segregated, and it seems a lot more like chopped up, or I should say it's partitioned rather. The memory coming from childhood seems to be like one continuous flow of uninterrupted memory, but recently a lot of edits have been done.
Oh.
Are you still there?
Oh, yeah. No, he just...
Okay, I saw the disconnect.
Yeah, I'm still here. Yeah, I heard the sound. Still connected.
Okay. Anyway. Yeah, you can see a bunch of recent memories where she has been essentially made by a accomplished Cyglider or observer, made into like assuming other personalities temporarily. It seems like those from anime personalities.
Gross.
What?
What a fucking loser, dude.
Yeah. Things of that nature. There doesn't seem to be a whole lot of, like, necessarily, let's say, great memories in the place that she's at. But you can see that, like kind of reaming back a bit, you can actually see what looks like a fairly interesting, like, cluster of memories that take place before a certain date that was essentially serialized in this unit's memory as a change of ownership, basically. You will need to make an interface roll if you want to mess with those. If not, you can just go in here and like start erasing shit.
Hawk really wants to interface. You could, crazy.
You can do it. I'm not stopping you. You're in there on your own right now, buddy.
That's right.
And honestly, like, so remember, this all happens
really
at the...
bad memories before?
No. She had good ones. I think that's what she said.
Yeah, she has memories that she's basically got in a partition of her brain that is saved as essentially, like, fond memories. It's where they would be typically located. Most of her current stuff is...
what about the stuff before her serialization transfer?
That's what I'm talking about. Like, everything before that is kind of contiguous. Nothing's been chopped up.
Considering that I'm doing brain running and it's super quick anyway, I'm not just like matters
of
seconds.
Say.
I wanna go look into it. I'm gonna roll.
All right.
I just wanna know.
I thought I was gonna say next was like it honestly happens at the speed of thought, so it's like we would barely notice the difference in time it took you if it was just to go in and delete versus you going in and poking around for a minute.
It's 13 for interface.
Okay, not bad. Getting closer to the memory cluster, you can see that there is some sort of facility like that's starting to edge out from the sides of like your peripheral vision. It's built into your mindscape piece by piece, and you start to realize like there's like these kind of warm, almost like factory or hospital looking kind of walls. It's meant to be kind of homey, almost like a recovery clinic or something like that, that can be remembered. And you can see there are a bunch of other people that look like her, and there's ones that look like a male line of her. These are instantly identified as you're like spelunking through her memory as Morgan units. Like the Lukes and the Lucias. They have male and female runs of this this line. All of them kind of similar. Brunettes, very shapely, good looking. They seem to be cohabitating in like this area of like a factory. And one of the memories in particular is them greeting one of the new replicants. In your memory, there's something strange, though. Like, while you understand all of the language, it seems to be kind of foreign to you. And after a moment, it's because you, you check your neural lattice, and it lets you know that you're speaking basically Chinese. Or these memories are in Chinese.
So, manufactured somewhere.
Yep.
Made in China.
Probably in Hong Kong, and the Japanese
you
government
through the,
Hong
Kong. Yeah, you like spool through the memories in this area, eventually coming to a couple like strolls in a park. And after a moment, you definitely see like a city skyline somewhere out there on a what looks like a bay or something like that. You can go ahead and roll knowledge local or library search if you want to search the internet for buildings. What skill are you using?
I'm going to use the library. Because I doubt I know local.
Library search? Okay, what's your total?
7.
What 12. Was it? Oh, 12.
Not too low on
12 is enough for a city skyline. Yeah, it definitely seems to be a skyline where you can see it recognize several of the more notable buildings in Hong Kong.
Yeah.
Hmm.
It looks like she has units that are considered to be like close friends of her. They are not all exactly the same. Their experience seemed to mold them, and they can tell one another apart in these memories, even though they all look basically identical. But this is where the happy memories basically end. Once she's serialized and put out on out in the market, her mind is been tampered with, so there's no contiguous line from that point on.
Okay. Cool. And that's all that's left here is, or basically that's all that I guess the memories of her brothers and sisters, and then it kind of, and then it stops, or it starts into kind of where her serialization occurred. So is it just him, like the current owner, or were there previous owners being recorded?
She seems to have some, like, some at least autonomy around this area. She's like trusted to go around and get groceries, and she has like fond memories with some of the like people in the building. Local kids she seems fascinated by. Just life in general over here. Even in the slums, it's so different from the factory, and like every experience, smell, everything, you know, it's all something that she holds as like a treasure, since, you know, in reality, she's about 4 years old. She has a lifetime of memories, but, like, she came off the production line not too long ago.
How hard is it to... Do I know how hard it is to, like, place memories? Like, do an insertion of memories in every place?
You know how it's done. It's not terribly difficult. The hardest thing is making them seamless.
Okay. Because what if I just want to do like little like snippets of memories? Like, okay, this sounds crazy. Like giving her parts of what my memory are, but it being like tailored more towards her, right? Like, I ideas of growing up, like kind of like near like Japantown, like being like me running around on the streets with all the other kids, or like coming home from school, like give her a couple memories like to leave her with. I'm taking memories from her, but I can leave her with like memories.
Why don't we just
similar to what I've experienced.
Oh, here's a fun idea.
You can edit.
Here's a fun idea. That. The last like 20 so minutes that we were here, have it just be her like leaving the apartment and finding some cool guys that she just hung out with on the street. So she wasn't even here when the place got robbed, as far as she remembers.
It's more difficult to make up memories because you have to like visualize themselves yourself.
And hey, well, how many times has Fuse been out on the roads with us and hanging out and just having a good time that he couldn't?
I'm not saying it's like impossible. I'm saying it's more difficult than giving one of your own memories.
Oh, like straight up, yeah. That's what I'm saying. Just give. Well, I'm. Why doesn't Fuse just give her like one of the party memories? Like she just went out and hung out with some people.
Well, that's up to Fuse.
Yeah, Fuse can think of that.
I was just gonna give her. I was just gonna give her like basically like a edited versions kind of what like I've experienced before. Just something to hold on to, like. Maybe like where she thinks she had, like I've seen her mom and dad allegedly.
Mm-hmm.
I can like make it where it seems like she has a sister, because I have a sister.
Mm-hmm.
And so like the imaging of like having grown up with a sister.
Here's what I'm thinking though, right? Those are all formative memories that they receive, right? Just to like give them like some kind of sense of personhood. But that's not what she really is clinging to. She's clinging to stuff that she's actually experienced.
Right.
But yeah.
She doesn't know that she's has or has not experienced.
No, she knows the difference based on like the fact that she's partitioned those memories off. Like she knows these are just like formative memories and she can use them to relate experiences to other humans when she's like engaging with human beings, right? Like, oh, I know what it's like to have family. I know what it's like to have a mother, have a father, so that I can seem more human, right? But this person was my brother.
Does she not believe that these are actually really?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Those are real people. That's people in really that are other replicants that she really had a relationship with in Hong Kong.
All right. Before we go too much farther with this, I want Hawk to make up the decision because.
I'm still gonna leave her with good. Yeah, I'm leaving her
in like a moment of time.
I'm leaving her with my own custom tailored like experience, but it's her instead. So like import her mom and dad or the image of said mom that she believes there's her mom, and like her running around as a kid, like going to the park, taking the trip to go like hiking, different stuff like that that I have done as a child. I want to leave her with those.
Okay.
As if she were me. And then my mom and my dad are actually her mom and her dad.
Okay. Go ahead and make a roll.
She has trauma watching her parents die in a dark alley.
Uh-oh.
6 plus 17. 17? 13.
Oh, see, that's a damn fine roll.
Shoot, oh.
13, okay. You begin to interlace these memories into her current, like, running memory. Putting them back into the partition where her upbringing is. This all seems like a fair amount easier. The way that the interface is built on this like frame is far less messy than the ones you've dove into up to this point. All right, what are you taking?
I'm taking out the last 8 minutes that we were here.
Oh, more than 8.
Well, I mean, yeah, I took, so like, I guess 15 or 20, however long we had been here. Basically, to the point that, like...
Where I put my gun to the back of her head.
I need you to head, yes.
Make a Pathfinder roll for me, please.
Oh, okay. I don't have any cards. 6, 7, 8... 15.
Okay. You're able to trace through her memories back to the point where she originally felt the gun at the back of her head.
Okay. I'm just gonna, like, just gonna remove that and make it where she just maybe closed her eyes. then she'll just basically she'll just wake up without us having.
Okay. Let's see. Do you have anything? Let's see. Go ahead and make a cloak roll. Okay.
Eyes don't even mean to... Ugh.
Alright, you embed old memories in her and basically update her sensorium with the edited memories at a 12.
Is there a way that you can have something that she can't remember but somebody else like visually locked kind of thing?
You haven't tried it, but it's possible.
Great.
I mean,
we're like wasting a little extra time anyway. We need to get out of here.
It's... All right, I'm gonna go. Well, while
subconscious is a thing.
When she when he first puts the electrodes on her head and like you know starts going in and it's like it seemed like they both drift off. I'd be walking over to like go over to the BD equipment and looking at it and picking out whatever looks fancy.
Okay.
And expensive.
You start looking over the BD equipment, and it's pretty obvious that this person is chopping memories out of these frames and selling them off as BDs.
Okay. Oh. Yeah. Yeah, I'm just grabbing whatever equipment that he has. He's doing it.
Bag.
I mean, it's worth good money, dude.
Still worth good money. I would like the equipment so that I can use to make my BDs better.
Okay. You're not going to be able to steal, like, the whole room worth of his shit.
Nah, not the whole room, but just, like, anything that's, like, small enough that's like, oh, this is actually a really good, like, little processor, you know? Take that.
You can't steal the room worth of shit. Well, we'll just go get the van, and we'll see about that.
We'll see about that, GM.
That'll take about 30 trips by the elevator.
Okay, all right. Yeah, go for it.
Jesus Christ.
Let's see how this turns out.
No, but seriously, I just like, you know, like I'm looking through like the equipment and just grabbing like expensive stuff. Maybe
the
a few of the BDs.
The stuff for you to grab is the BDs. You can sell all of these BDs.
Yeah, okay, then like, I'm just going to take the BDs. Yeah, I'm just
going
to take
the BDs. You can grab like a crate of them.
Yep, then that's what I do. I just grab the BDs themselves. Like I'm going to probably go through them myself, see how he edits them, see what's going on, and then sell them myself later on.
But it's like, you know what Judy's setup looks like in 2077?
Yeah.
Basically something similar to that. So
okay.
Yeah, it's like.
There's no, like, component
and,
parts that I can just take and... Okay. Fuck it, I take the monitor off the fucking...
I mean, it's all stuff like that. Like, you can take a piece here and there, but you can only carry so much.
Yeah.
And, you know, you need the
I definitely grab the BDs.
Work.
Yeah, I grab the BDs and maybe one of the monitors and...
as far as monetizing it goes, grabbing the BDs is going to be the biggest cash cow.
Yeah. I just start, like, sliding the BDs into a box. And pick up the box.
Alright, I'm done.
Done?
Yep.
Alright, disconnect.
Yeah.
Alright, we good? As I'm like, you know, standing there with my crate of BDs now under my arm.
Are you gonna leave her asleep?
For the time being.
Because, I mean, it defeats the purpose if you leave her awake when you leave.
Yeah, leave her asleep.
I assumed that she'd be asleep now that I have her memory.
Yeah, you set her brain into the somnium state, and she basically just leans or, like, slumps over on the couch.
I'll lay her down as if, like, she had just laid down.
Fell asleep.
Little pillow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, you know, thumbs up to fuses. I'm holding my BDs under my arm now. Good?
Yeah,
when you come out, Fuse, when you come out, of the sensorium, you feel like your whole body feels like sticky, but you're not actually sticky. Like something is clinging to you. Maybe just raw emotion. It's not exactly unpleasant, but it's not exactly pleasant either.
My character be able to potentially, like, consider the fact that he just ran, like, an artificial mind and see if maybe, like, that would be what would be sticking to him? or what that sticky feeling could potentially be?
Yeah, it's called guilt.
Yeah.
All right, I'm killing myself.
I look at Fuse, like, you know, same thing like I said before, you know, a thumbs up, we good, Fuse?
I dive out the window.
Oh, fuck, we're not good at all.
No. No, God, no, my he's not good.
Not good.
Yeah,
not
I don't know
good.
What you would roll to discern that, but, yeah, you just feel particularly morose.
Good? No? Yes?
Yes.
You all leave right. Knowing that you leave this person, or this unit, here, with, Soejima.
Ugh. Fucking creep. Yeah, dude. Oh my god, just let her free, man.
You know, I said that
that's
before.
That's sticking to you.
I said that before. I said, if anything, we'd be liberating.
That's what I was saying, man.
I mean, if y'all want me to factory reset her, why didn't you just say that?
No.
And it really bothers me.
And it happened in a moment, so...
Yeah.
All right. Look, and you know, in, as we're like,
gonna take a second and a half.
As we're stepping out of the door, I go, Fuse.
Are you wanting me to reset her and let her just go roam
you
free?
You shut up for a second. I'm sorry I said that to you. All right.
I don't think you are, but
no, I really am. I shouldn't have gone there, but we needed to get this done. And yanking the fucking thing. I don't know if they're tracking it. I don't know what they're doing to it. I don't know how they're using it. The fact is, I've seen that thing near. I've seen one of those things nearly kill one of our friends. And I don't want to risk it doing that to us. And I don't want to risk it being coming after us.
That one's programmed not to be able to do physical harm to people.
I didn't know that. I'm just terrified of them, okay? But we did the right thing, all right? Look, you did the right thing. You have Haruna's frame. We can go fix your girlfriend. I put my hand on his shoulder as I say this.
Ark starts walking out of the bedroom. Oh, we got Haruna's frame? All right, we're good to go. He's stuffing something into his bag.
I'm going to tell the guys, I also have these two. I'm going to kind of show them the little digital display. One of them is Daphne Farrow. The other one is...
Oh, sweet. Not so sweet. That's kind of gross, actually. They
not so sweet.
Yeah. Like, hey, wait a minute. Did they steal her brain after she was dead?
Only one way to find out. Incidentally, if you don't want that Gresh to, like, you know, die, never tell Gresh Shenzi about this.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. We're good. Oh, also, all let's right. not mention the fact that we have Daphne Farrow's.
Yeah, let's not mention that at all. State.
I don't think we need to
let's figure this out first.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
You're not here, bud.
Huh?
We're walking downstairs.
We're walking out of here. Let's go.
Incidentally, did I actually find anything?
Talk about buttered sausage.
Yes.
Excellent.
That tastes so good.
He definitely found more mech warrior stuff, more BattleTech stuff that he wanted.
You guessed it right. Yeah. You definitely guessed it right.
The other ones, though, too.
What I typed to X was Ark, which is to search around for the bedroom for any BattleTech merchandise.
All right, I'm eagerly trying to get downstairs as fast as
I know my people.
I'm blocking cameras on the way down.
We're also taking the one for Wendell and
concentration, please.
Yeah. I know my people. I know the things they use to get under their skin to abuse them.
18.
18. Okay.
Yep.
As you guys walk through the hallways, you're able to pin the cameras. Basically stop them from working as you pass through the area.
Nice. Beautiful.
Alright, you make your way down out of the building.
Getting in Jimbo's pedo van.
Yep.
Excuse me. Not a pedo van, this has class.
Oh, sorry, your grape van.
Your great van?
Great van.
I have puppies.
He's not
gonna grape you forever and ever and ever.
Forever and ever. I'm gonna rape you in the mouth.
You guys aren't seeing why this is a bad marketing decision to say grape you in the mouth to kids?
No, we're
going to
grape him in the mouth.
Right, Jimbo, hold
fast. Time's a radiator and grape him in the mouth.
Where are we going?
Home, please.
Start heading home. or back to the warehouse.
I'm about to tell them where we're going.
Right.
The new home.
All right. I look at Dez.
As we're like piles into the cars.
Yeah, as we're driving away, I look at Dez and I go, "God, they gotta stop making him sexy."
Making what sexy?
Did I hear you say that you were afraid of them?
Yes.
The big
dude. We watched one drag Crescentia across solid concrete.
No, I understand, but you know,
by her head.
But you're so big, like, and strong and tough now, and you never get shot.
Ever.
I hate you, Dez. I hate you so much, man. I should have let you just fuck the weird fucking pseudo person. Someone have to hear your bullshit now.
Well, you're stuck with me. That's just.
What you mean, like the exotic you were making googly eyes at?
Exotic? What? No, the.
On the rig?
I thought an exotic was like people that were into like having fur.
Yep.
Yep.
Fur, exotic tails.
Yeah.
Cartilage fucking tails. You name it.
Right.
Fish people.
Right.
I mean, yeah. Sometimes you want to spice it up a little bit.
Can I contact Hartman on the way home?
Yeah, probably.
I don't know, can you?
He runs your bouncer.
Well, I mean, if he's busy,
got him.
You know?
Got him.
If he's busy, I mean, he might not answer.
Armin's like the best multitasker to ever exist.
I mean, he multitasks at the beat of electric, so...
I would like Hartman to speak to me in Jamaican patois now.
Oh, God.
He'll do it.
He'll do it, too.
Tell you how you know. I'd be working in the other side. You know them things. Oh, we're happening in the other place, in China.
Alright, so what are you doing? Are you going to actually contact Hartman?
Yes.
What do you say?
Hey, Hartman, I have recovered this frame for Haruna. What's the steps that I need to take to go ahead and reinstate? Anything I need to know? Is there a procedure?
You'll have to reintroduce it to her using your side glider.
Okay. Should
the
I...
steps are pretty straightforward, but of course there is always the situation in which if you update the frame as it stands, it was going to be back to the time in which it was taken, essentially killing the Haruna that lived in between.
Okay. Is there any compromised way that I can reinstate the old without damaging the current state, without wiping it completely?
I believe that Screaming Neon is working on a process currently in order to make the jump over
Hang on a second, I'm looking for the word, I can't think of it right now. What is it?
You gotta reconcile the two states is basically what you're saying, right?
Thank you. Hold on. Now, I figured out the word I was looking for.
He's currently going through a process to verify the continuity of the brain state that he's trying to save.
Okay. Do you know what progress he's at? Is it worth trying right now? Or is it a little too risky?
From what I understand, he lacks the brain state that he is attempting to get hold of.
So, would this offer him that said brain state? I mean, the worst situation that could come out would be I just basically start her back at the brain state from when this point basically ended. She loses whatever she's done up to this point for the last month or so, which would, yes. I guess, in turn, that would kind of mess up what you were doing with working with her, and I don't know if that would be particularly bad or good any which way. Is it?
It would certainly be a setback to me, but not an insurmountable one.
I mean, if you have both her and I helping you, would that potentially expedite what we're needing to get done? I'll be happy.
I currently have 72 technicians working for me at this moment in time.
Oh.
Well, losing one would not be catastrophic, but it would be a considerable setback.
I suppose that's true.
Each person is working on a part of code that is individualized to their experience, to their particular field. It would mean that I would have to find somebody, or wait to retrain that person, in order to fill the gap in knowledge that I need.
Do you have a way for me to contact Screaming Neon?
Yes, I have his information as well.
Can you route it to me, please? I'll see if maybe we can use this brain state. It's fully intact, 100%. Maybe we can use this brain state and what he's also researched. This might be what he needs.
I'm sure he'll be thrilled to find that out.
Perfect. Yeah, patch me through to him, or send me his information. I'll contact him immediately.
Maybe I'll send you his information.
Thank you.
Also, I can tell that you're in transit at the moment. You should probably do yourself a favor and stay out of the downtown Los Angeles area.
You got problems happening down that area?
What's he doing?
Indeed, there is a team that is currently searching for my location. They've isolated the areas around here.
Ooh, okay. Okay, good. Thank you for the warning. Yeah, we'll take an alternate detour as I tell, I mean, I'm sure this is on, like, speakerphone, so everybody in the vehicle can hear it, so Jimbo knows the route.
Is there anything that... adjustments to avoid downtown.
Is there anything that you need help with that I could do for you right now, Hartman, or are you still kind of okay for the time being?
At the moment, no, but I would clear your schedule in the future for a possible trip to Hong Kong.
Yeah, I found some information that was quite interesting. I found a brain state from... I can't say this guy's name. Azeo Kazu... Kozuki...
Ozusao.
There we go. That guy!
Who?
That's fantastic news. Streaming Neon will definitely be thrilled to hear it.
Perfect. I figured he would. I just thought maybe I'd let you know as well, which I'm sure he'd tell you. Anyway, big gains for us today. Hopefully this helps improve some research for everybody. Anyway, I'll get back with you hopefully shortly with some answers, and like I said, yeah, we'll clear up our schedule and be ready to go potentially. I just need to get her brain state situated back out. Do anything else.
I understand. All right, wish you luck.
Thank you, Hartman.
Of course.
And I dive out of the van. Head for...
Oh, duck and roll.
I'm out. Okay. I'll contact Screaming Neon.
All right, one moment. Dez.
Yes.
You're sitting there staring out the window after all of this has been going on, and you feel like you've kind of like fallen asleep in a matter of sorts. Just the hum of the vehicle, everything kind of jostling you. And it feels almost like your mind has gone into like a neutral state.
Okay.
To you, the sensation would be the closest to sleeping, but it's almost like being able to control it, like a lucid dream.
Yeah.
There's something begging at the edge of your periphery for some sort of interaction. It's got a pull on you that is unlike anything you've really ever experienced. Like, something wants to happen. If only you could figure out what it was. If only you could do the thing. Something would really change everything. You're on the verge of it. You sit there in your sleep, just sort of thinking about everything that's been going on and digesting it. It feels almost like
man.
Your thoughts are...
You can just slap that. You can just slap that brain state. You know what I mean? I can be anybody. Let's go.
What's that?
I said just slap the brain state for any of these people into me, and because I have the mental, like, because I can reach, I can change my face and everything, it's like literally you could just be that person, right? Is that how we would set the profile or whatever to do?
That's certainly an interesting idea.
Try it. Desmond's just an idea, man. He doesn't even have to exist. Doesn't even matter.
At the end of the day, what really are you?
Yep.
Your mind kind of reels in the abyss, the thought of the concept.
Yeah,
a moment later, you kind of shake awake, and you can see, like, the familiar streets of the Lakewood area.
Yeah.
As you guys are making your way back around to Terminal Island. In the distance, you can see the Santa Rita. All right. You guys are heading back to the warehouse?
Yeah. X, I really hate to do it, but I'm going to have to go. My whole face is hurting.
I understand, man. Thank you very much for staying as long as you did. You got to see at least the part that I wanted you to see.
Go get some corn.
Yeah, I'm going to go put some frozen corn on my face.
Thank you very much for putting up for all the parts you weren't there for, which was all of them.
Yeah. And y'all making fun of my fucking van. That's it. None of y'all are allowed anymore.
I didn't make fun of the van. I'm going to point that out. I didn't make fun of the van.
Complex isn't allowed because he smells.
I don't smell.
Bye, guys.
Later.
Yeah, take care, man. Feel better.
Anyway.
What happened to Sid's face?
He got a...
He had a root canal.
Root canal, yep. So he is in pain. He tried. Now we just assume Jimbo is back by his van, just working on it for the rest of this night.
Yep, you guys pull back up to the warehouse.
Makes it easy for us not to mention us.
I need to contact.
Anybody else doing anything?
I'm sorry, say again?
Anybody else doing anything?
Did we get to the warehouse?
Yep.
Alright, I'm getting outside and I'm going to unpack.
Carrie's in a...
As far as you go, you got a, basically in the box, limited edition, model of a Battletech mech that's, relatively rare. It's worth a couple grand, on the trading market. It also has a unique code inside it in the game in order to, get the mech in your fleet. In the actual game.
Nice.
It's obviously never been opened by this collector, but you could make good use of it.
Hell yeah. Ark will take it up to the loft and put it on like a table or something.
Plus you have a bitchin' like model you can build now.
Hell yeah.
Alright.
Yeah, I was wondering why we were listening to attention for a couple seconds. You're just like, am I about to fucking, like, unspool my model and explode?
Yeah, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now we'll go back to the real music now.
No! No, don't be kidding!
I fucking knew it.
As soon as I fucking looked at the list of chilling at home, I knew exactly which one you were going for.
Yep.
Yeah. Bitch, I'm a cow.
This shit cracks me up.
Written at 3 a.m. in 20 minutes. Anyway, I'm going to go sit down and start sorting through the BDs, seeing if any of them are labeled, and they are.
It's mostly smut.
It probably is mostly smut.
Yeah.
No, it's, I mean, there's probably some in there as well, but it's, a mix of memories. So, in the similar way that, like, smut, like, like, people are into some weird off-the-wall shit and stuff that you'd never think of is, like, stuff that gets somebody off or whatever. Mm-hmm. In that same vein, brain dance is like that. You know, like, sometimes you just can't put the price on, you know, finding the right pair of, like, comfy sweatpants at a store. You know, like, it's so off-the-wall, like, what people like, and in BD markets, there's, like, entire, like, search engines that are designed around finding the right, like, thing that somebody wants to, you know.
New car smell BD.
Yeah. You know, just finished mowing the lawn, cracking a beer. Like, you know, nobody's got an actual fucking lawn anymore, except for, like, super rich people, but, you know, just weird shit like that. Working in a wood shop. You know, all kinds of stuff. But the box that you have has quite a lot of stuff to go through. Like, literally hours and hours of memory.
Man, that guy's gonna be pissed, huh?
Probably rent. Probably could easily pay his rent for the next few months with these.
Well, no, there are. Fuck him.
Yeah.
That guy's a creep.
I mean, he's working with the people that have a fucking bomb that can wipe out Los Angeles, so I don't think he's hurting for cash.
So for reference,
just hope he doesn't have his finger on the detonator, huh?
For reference, X, what Complex will do is, like, if the BDs have names labeled to them or any information that, like, associates it with people, he's gonna, like, you know, sort them into piles based on that. Because he might, like, try and keep, like, more famous people BDs and hold on to them while, like, first, like, or the famous people BDs, he might start selling those off first to make more money, and then keeping the lower end or the less conspicuous ones, like this is a private person, and it's like only he could have acquired this.
After a few hours, like, when you get back home of checking through these BDs, it's pretty obvious that these are not, there's no celebrities here.
Okay, so these BDs are
coming off of out of somewhere, like a private selection of normal, pretty normal ass people.
Okay. So he's grabbing frames, making the BDs from the frames, and then, Jesus Christ, it's fucking dark. Alright, I'm like, you know, as I'm going through them and figuring it out and realizing that none of this is, like, anything particular, nothing that, like, would just appear on the net, like, so easily, like, immediately look at Dez and I'm like, I'm just gonna have to sell these in bulk.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think I can sell these off. Like,
I could pick up one and I show him the label and it's like, you know, it's just sitting on a back porch drinking a beer and it's some nobody.
So? Oh, wait. Okay.
You see where I'm coming from. It's like, these aren't BDs that might be people who normally do BDs out there.
They're not for... No, bro, they're not for you to sell.
No, I'm not going to sell them. I'm just saying, like, if we started selling them, it's... People will notice. Particularly that guy will notice and know what happened.
Oh. Yeah, that's why you use a fence.
Well, yeah, I mean, you obviously use a fence, but I would rather just give the fence the box and let them deal with it.
That's why you give the box to me.
Yes, which I'm now sliding it over to you.
And I take care of it. That's... Yes.
There we go. You get it. All right, good. Just take it off my hands. I was going to try and do it, but honestly, I can't do this. I can't touch it.
Yeah, no, it's fine. Yeah, I'll take care of it. How many are in there?
How many are in there?
How many... Do you just want me to write a box of
Slice of Life BDs?
I mean, you can do that if you want. The more you know about it, the more you'll be able to probably get from the hall.
Yeah. I know what I have. No lowballing.
Watch the BDs, like, so you can categorize them.
I know what I have. No lowballing.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll,
I could spend the time to watch all of them.
Yeah,
if you want me to. Oh, fuck, I really don't want to go through all of them.
Well, I mean, that's the only way to know if some of those ones are really good, right?
Look, I just did another one before I finally gave up here. We have a BD rig, right? We do have a BD in the group, right? I was like, yeah, so he commonly says, the last one I just watched was literally a dude just walking down the street, and it was a breeze. It was a very nice breeze, but that's all it was.
Were there other people on the street?
I mean, yeah. It was like a February or something.
What was it, like sub 100 or something?
Yeah,
it was sub 100.
Nice breeze. Just a couple people on the street, maybe like...
It was pretty nice.
Kids playing basketball or something, no cars. You know?
Nice. I don't think this was edited. I think this was straight up a memory.
Oh. Well, that's dumb.
That's what I'm saying, though. Most of it's just, like, shit like that. Like, the last four I've been through are just that.
So you guys gonna spend some time going through the BDs to make sure you can categorize them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Why not?
We make a team effort. We'll cut down the man hours from 10 to 3. Our total work time from ten hours to 3 hours. I mean, the man hour, the actual work hours are still going to be the same. It's still 10 hours across the board. It's just between five of us, we managed to shorten it down.
We all share it around if it's a good one.
Yeah, we keep it. We all jerk off to the same BD. It's very gross.
Oh.
No, thank you.
No, clearly I know you have a type.
You guys are sitting there going through the BDs, checking them all out. Yeah, they seem largely just like strange experiences, like just really casual, normal moments, but obviously of interest to somebody. Let's see, complex.
Mm-hmm.
While you're sitting there diving through these BDs, you're kind of like going through one of them where a guy's walking through a tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
It's like just a single man tunnel or like a bicycling tunnel, and walking through, and there's actually kind of a cool breeze like you were talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like basically alone, except for like there's one passerby at the midpoint of the way under it. And looking out at the end, like you can see like the light out there. And You feel something strange, like, tugging at your, like, sensorium. Some sort of, like, strange alert or something. Something waiting for something to happen.
You said there was one person that passed.
Uh-huh.
Hmm. Is it, like...
Something's changed about this BD. It's not what you expect out of it.
I go back. Okay, so I'm like taking that. I'm gonna reset my perception. And I'm gonna go back to a few of the BDs and see if I like spot similarities between people or 6-4. So 10 plus 28. Nice. I actually got a good roll on perception.
What are you running? All
right. Perception, and I'm gonna start going back through BDs and like. Looking for, like, faces and people and, like, trying to see if there's, like, similarities. Like, are all these happening in, like, the same area, same neighborhoods?
You think about, you go to pop the BD out. And when you pop it out, you feel the player in your hand, the remote. You click the media out of the device, and you're sitting in the tunnel still. Someone's walking down the tunnel towards you.
Uh-oh.
Somebody's walking down the tunnel towards you. You look down, you're like, shit, I just stopped this. Mm-hmm. You mentally turn your brain dance player off. And you feel like the brain dance stop. You see like the schematics from your brain dance player or the readout. Letting you know that the BD's ended. You pull the cassette out of the machine and look up and you're in the tunnel again. You can see someone walking down the tunnel towards you.
Try it again. I'm like, you know, no, this isn't
again,
right.
Again, the media comes out. You pull the cassette away. Look up from the player, from the control. You see the tunnel.
I turn around and I try and, like, you know, go back down the other way down the tunnel.
You turn around and you're in, like, basically you just see darkness. And there's something beyond the darkness that feels like it's asking for something.
You know,
something you can't explain.
So Complex is like, you know, kind of jog, trying to like, there's got to be an exit. It's got to be there. And then he stops, turns around again, starts running back towards the person where they were coming from.
Okay.
And heading for the light. He's just going to like, try and blow past the person and head for the light.
Okay. The person that you passed in the tunnel is Daphne. She sees you as you run past.
You know, I skirt to a stop, turn, look, Daphne?
Complex? Where are you going?
This isn't real. What are you doing here? Why am I here?
I would say the same thing about you.
Why am I here? What is going on? I was just playing a BD.
That's a good question. I don't remember how I got here.
I was just playing a BD. You shouldn't be here. And I, like, you know, just wag my finger. I can't, like, bring the words that you're dead out.
I feel like... I feel like I'm asleep.
Yeah, you are. I gotta get out of here. And I, like, you know, turn. I kind of, like, turned, and I turned back to her. I go, I'm sorry, Daphne. I gotta get out of here. And I just start running for the light again.
Okay. You turn to the white of the light. and there's something that wants input. You don't know what it is, but it's something that wants you to give it something. A command, an idea. There's something more than what's going on here. There's something you're supposed to be a part of that you're missing.
Okay. Stops running, you know. Does he feel winded?
You do. You feel okay. Tired, yeah.
Stops running. Takes a breath.
You're sweating.
Turns around to the darkness and goes, "What do you want? Let me out!"
You just hear your voice kind of echo in the tunnel. You don't see Daphne anymore. Turning back to the light, you see the tunnel and someone walking down it.
Is it Daphne again?
You'll have to run back up there.
All right, start with me, you know.
Tired, you're jogging again.
Yeah.
Jog down the tunnel. This time, it's Haruna.
God damn it. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. Why are you here now?
Haruna, Complex, what are you doing here?
I am trying to get out. I grab her by the arms. I'm trying to get out. What do I have to do? How did you get in here?
I don't know how I got in here. Where's Akui? Is he with you?
He's outside. I'm trying to get outside. I just want out. I'm tired of this place. What do I have to do? You're smart. What do I have to do?
She takes your hand, and you feel something go into your hand. When you look down at it, you can see it looks like a BD, like a brain dance.
Okay.
You look down at the brain dance, and you just feel exhausted. How many times have you been through this loop? Complex, you realize that you're actually sitting in the room in the warehouse. And the other guys are doing their BDs right now. You have what looks like a specific BD in your hand.
So
it's
is
not
there
one that you've played? It's somehow got into your hands.
Okay. I hold it for a minute and I go, think about it, and I go, fine, I'll look at it and I'll put it in and start playing it.
Okay. It's a brain dance from a memory. And you can see that it's Haruna's memory. She's watching Fuse, who is cooking for her in the morning before she goes to school. You can feel like all of her love, like an admiration that he gets up so early and does this every morning, make sure that she gets off to school. Something about it makes you feel just absolutely fantastic, loved in a way you haven't really felt lately.
Hankering for good wienery.
You get 3 points of humanity back.
Ooh! Right.
That was 3. Sorry, that's 4. There you go.
Call some of that good wienery and you might get another one.
Hold on, where is it? There was a meme.
You realize that amongst these BDs are the BDs of the people likely that you found. These are memories chopped out of their, or I should say at least copied out of their frames.
I wanna, as soon as this one's over, I was like, I take it out and I go to Fuse. And I hand it to him and I go, hey man, look, I'm really sorry I used the thought of your girlfriend against you. And I just kind of hand him the BD and like say, that one's for you, buddy.
Is he actually doing this? Or is...
Wait, I can't understand you through the roboting.
Help!
Oh, it's back. Hello? Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Hello?
Yeah.
We're back. Oh, we're so back.
We're so back, baby. Okay, what were you saying?
Okay, as far as in like real meat space.
Yeah.
Is Complex actually handing me something?
Yeah, I'm actually handing you something in meat space. Yeah, I've come to you with a BD and I've given it to you in meat space. Like, this one's for you, man.
So Complex is not caught in his loop then?
No, not in my loop anymore.
Okay, I'll...
I escaped the loop.
I'll take the BD from him. What is this supposed to be?
It's the one of Haruna watching you cook for her and feeling, like, really nice about you and loving you. I'm and wanting some disrespectful dicking.
Oh, God. God. I'm going to hand it back to him. If you want it, you can keep it.
No.
I already have this memory.
No, you don't have this memory.
I do, though.
No.
Wait. It dawns on you. Somebody has a box full of your girlfriend's memories. Or at least they're in there, too.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we're not selling them, so...
No, we're selling them. We're sorting through... That's what we were doing for the last couple of minutes, is that we were sorting through them. Or hours or so at this point. We're sorting through them to figure out what's on them, so that way we can categorize them and sell them for more money.
We'll keep this one and put all of hers together that you find. And then you can get her permission. Otherwise, we scrap them.
I think we just scrap them, buddy. These are your girlfriends. This is important to you.
Yeah, they're technically hers. So,
I mean, do you want to go ask her permission to sell her memories? Because we all know how that conversation goes. That we're taking from her without her consent. We know how that conversation goes, right? You know how that conversation goes, right?
Right, but they're her memories, so.
They're her memories that were taken from her without her consent.
I went and removed these because I don't know if these are copies or these are cutouts. So
that's what I'm saying. We keep these regardless. We're not selling them. We're not even mentioning them to her.
That's why I'm handing it back to you. Keep this and organize them all together so I don't lose one. I want all of them together.
Okay. Okay, I'm following you now.
Put them in like a little pouch or something. Little manila envelope.
All right, so I'm doing the same thing for now that it's been mentioned. I'm doing the same thing for Daphne now, and same thing for homeboy. Fucking not his name now. Oliver. Oliver. Same thing for Oliver. If I find Oliver memories, I'm just keeping them to the side.
Daphne's experiences are decidedly more harrowing. And they generally revolve around her basically coming out of really wild shit and, like, always looking for Jimbo.
I assemble these, and I'm considering giving it to Jimbo, but I'll touch on that later.
You find a memory of Daphne coming out of a coma and Jimbo being there.
Definitely probably going to give it to Jimbo.
All right, it's time to get a synth and upload all of these memories for Jimbo. Now he'll have Daphne 2.0.
I mean, if we wanted to complete the trifecta of fucked up, we could have just taken the Gresh and overrode her.
That's definitely true.
Yeah, but
then you're using a used nasty bot.
Besides, also that that's a whole difference.
Those are used goods. I want a fresh model.
Virgin.
You sure you agent?
What? Hold up. What?
Virgins without any debt, right?
Oh, I didn't say that.
I need to take a break, and I'm gonna get Complex is gonna get up and you know, from the BD running, and just go out. And I think our little warehouse is like near a port, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's off Terminal Island.
Okay. Yeah. So he's just gonna walk until like he reaches essentially the ocean front and just kind of like sit out there for a while.
Okay. Yeah. Reality's getting slipperier for you. And you know it. But what the fuck was that, you think to yourself? Where is it? There you are.
Called conscience transference.
Hey, Fuse, question.
Answer.
So, we could, like, take... Well, hypothetically, could we take these frames, right?
Yep.
And essentially, because with the neural lattice, we have the ability to have like a spare compartment, right? So, like, we could at will switch between different personas.
I guess, technically speaking, I imagine that would be possible.
Or at least have access to.
I mean, we swap consciousness between the lattice, so, but we're also alive, and.
Right.
I don't know if these frame states are. They're not particularly alive, they're just the memories of.
Yeah, but that's the point, is that the memories inform the character, right?
But the problem I think you'd run into would be if you upload that to be your. Consciousness, then your consciousness is gone. So, will you know to switch back? I don't think so. Kind of like how Morgana is kind of just programmed to be who she is, then it'd be like you just completely reprogrammed your mind and body. I don't think you would know to go back.
I mean, unless there's some sort of underlying...
Yeah, it'd be right. Something beyond what I would know to do.
I'm wondering if there's a way that we could set this up where I could have access to those memories.
BDs of all these other people's memories, right?
Right.
I mean, what I worry about is... Like, these are like, we have the frames, and then we have BDs.
Yeah.
I know it's possible to overwrite your brain right now. I can overwrite your brain with somebody else's brain. And you, I guess, potentially could fail to exist. But at the same time, I don't think it's a full copy. I don't know.
It doesn't need to be a full copy.
Is it just memory? Is there a full consciousness?
Are you asking me esoteric questions?
This is just theoreticals. I don't know.
Because I don't know, and I don't really care.
Yes, Brian. Yes, it's a bunch of data, and eventually some of it's going to overwriting.
Yeah, I mean, it gets overwritten anyway because like your memory sucks. My memory sucks.
It does?
That's why everything seems junk, like, months later.
Well.
Unless you had some particularly harrowing experience.
I don't know. My worry would be if you take on those memory states, mm-hmm. How do you ensure that you don't lose your memory states? That's what worries me. I don't know if the neural lattice holds on to... yours and then runs the other ones, you know what I mean?
I mean, the thing is that I don't necessarily need access to every detail about the thing. I just need the ability to access the memories in the same way that I access mine right now.
I mean, I guess you could have a brain dance plugged in and not playing. Is that what you mean?
No, Not exactly. Because I don't.
Or
wanna,
you just want every wanna... memory on tap, and you can just access that memory.
Right, like it's a database that you can search, right? And you can just dip into it whenever you need it.
I don't know. That might be a limitation of the lattice we haven't explored yet. As far as can it handle multiple states of different memory. You know what I mean?
Sure, but I mean, I guess I'm just like, there's all these separate profiles, right, that you might have access to for, like, I don't know, your keyboard, you know, your computer. Like, why couldn't you have separate profiles like that for, like, personalities?
You know who would probably have an answer to this? The war boss.
Yeah, probably.
Although
what she's doing is a little different, but yeah.
Right, but I mean, the war boss has not always been like the same war boss forever, right? Like it gets transferred to somebody else, doesn't it?
I don't know that technology was necessarily always available, because the neural lattice was a fairly recent thing, right?
Well, I just thought they took the memories of one and then let it become the memories of the next, and it kind of became like all those people.
I mean, sure, but
you know what I mean? I don't know.
Yeah, but,
I feel like
true. Like it probably would have been like there's brain dances or something or some sort of construct, but I don't imagine that until the introduction of the neural lattice that a bunch of that stuff you could have even done.
All right, but I imagine if somebody is going to know about pulling like on-demand memories from like other war boss, it would be the current one, right? Especially since we know that they have a neural lattice. I bet they've used it like to that degree.
Right.
Like I know that they can like they can conscious swap. I know they can do that. So
we all know we can do that one.
We should ask. We should see if we can contact
Screaming Neon.
Well, I do need to contact Screaming Neon too. He might know, but
yeah.
I think it'd be interesting to ask the War Boss if they know anything about it. Plus, wouldn't hurt to do a checkup and see how everybody on that side's doing too. I don't know. To answer your question, I don't know if that's possible. I don't see why not. I mean, your mind is basically just a storage device.
Right.
Why can't you just, you know, plug in a second storage device?
Right.
It seems probable.
Alright. Yeah, we'll keep that in mind, I guess. Alright, well.
Well, all this philosophizing has got me hungry. You guys want fajitas?
Cup of fart and throw it in his face.
Oh, son of a bitch!
Roller's his pink eye.
Don't make me fucking scream at you. I can do it in German now. I don't know how.
Did you learn German, or is this just a skill chip?
I don't fucking know. All of a sudden, I was just speaking German.
Oh, that's not weird at all.
I'm gonna net speak Dez. I think he might be slowly merging conscious with Hilda.
Yeah, he's got a bit of a problem.
Yeah. We might want to keep an eye on this guy.
Yeah, it's not... Well,
so is that a no on the fajitas, or...?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm 100% down for fajitas.
Don't you want something more German?
That's a no on the fajitas. Alright.
No, I want fajitas. No, I want fajitas.
My character was looking at Dez when he said that, and he starts turning around.
I don't know. I just thought you'd want. I thought you'd want some Wiener Schnitzel.
Wow.
Yeah.
You mean like the one you stuffed in your mouth?
Some bratwurst.
Some yeah.
Sauerkraut.
What are you doing right now, Efren?
Me?
I mean,
I'm working on my rifle.
Nicolas Gisbe.
Yes.
Gisbe.
No.
Gisbe.
No.
God damn it!
Truly, we are the voice of a generation.
I need a contact for me available.
Alright. So you're working on your rifle at the moment?
Yes.
Okay. What are you doing to the rifle?
I'm installing my smart gun link and getting it all tuned up.
Did you already make a roll for that?
I have not yet.
Go ahead and make a weaponsmith roll. Alright. It's enough to install a smart gun.
Perfect. And then I'd like to do a tech roll to give it the plus one to hit.
Okay, I can upgrade. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Very nice. Okay.
And then I want to start, if we have the, what facility are we in right now? We're in like
the upgrade is going to take, amount in, resources from you. I know you guys have a running list.
Yeah.
I think it's one level lower than the, cost of the rifle.
Okay. Did we move the like CNC machine from the old shop to this place?
The lathe, yeah.
Not a lathe.
I want to start working on a suppressor for my AMR.
Okay.
Woof. It's not going to make it silent, but it won't kill your ears the next time you use it. Potentially.
Exactly.
You're going to be really mad when that gun falls out of the back of a van and we can't.
Hey now.
You're a rock star.
Don't go saying things you're gonna regret.
Get laid.
Don't go saying things I'm gonna regret.
Like, hey guys, let's go steal that Excalibur.
I think they forgot about the Excalibur, thankfully. Complex, what are you doing? Just sitting there,
sitting on the pier. He pops up his agent and he calls Z.
Okay.
Now he's just sad. Oh.
Damn.
How are you?
I'm good. What is this about?
Well, I want to see how you're doing. Been away for a while.
Yeah, you have been.
Is everything okay? You're...
Complex, you left for 2 weeks without saying anything.
It was...
completely unable to be contacted with. I thought you were dead.
I know how it seemed,
and when you get back, you're out gallivanting with your friends.
I'm sorry. I am truly, truly sorry I didn't tell you what happened before I ended up on an oil rig out in the middle of the ocean that's owned by the Jodes. I understand that you were probably afraid.
Yeah, I thought you were dead.
I know I messed up. I should have said something before I left. I'm alive. I'm well. And I'm more importantly happy to know that you're still alive and you're still well.
glad you're alive too.
Do you want to go get something to eat?
Yeah.
Alright. I'll be back soon. I'll see you there in like maybe 20. I'll get a cab over. Maybe go get some Thai food or some dumplings. Whatever you want.
Okay.
Alright. Alright, he hangs up. He basically just says, I love you, and hangs up real quick.
Okay.
And, oh, super cab. Super cab.
Super cab.
Super cab.
You go to go iron things out with Z.
Yeah. He saw the point of view of a woman who loves her man and was like, God damn it, I fucked up.
Oh, nice of you to think that that's the same relationship you have. That's a bold statement.
My woman looks at me with love. Your woman looks at you with hatred.
God damn, he's an idiot.
We are not the same.
This guy's a fucking wolf. Holy
he's
shit.
Like, why do I love that goddamn fool?
Mine loves me. Yours has vengeance against you.
She's just buying her time to kill me.
She'll love you just to spite you.
That's what I want. That's the relationship I want.
I want that.
Alright. So yeah, you're gonna have to figure out how to go forward. You have Haruna's frame. You as a group, I mean. Mm-hmm. You have Daphne's frame. But there are some obvious, like, philosophical questions that you need to tackle about how and what you want to do with these things.
No, we don't.
There's always the weird science approach, which I'm a huge fan of.
Say again?
Yeah, just do it, and
there's always the weird science approach, which I'm always a huge fan of.
Look, stop asking if we should, and just, can we do? Just do it.
Just swing for the fences, who gives a shit?
Exactly. We should. Which is another question I was thinking about was, you know who might buy a lot of brain dances? Just because, like, you know, think Grushes. Like, if they have some level of autonomy, if they're out there just hiding among people and they know that they're replicants, right? The easiest way for them to, like, become more, like...
More human than human?
More human than human would be just experience as many different, like, mundane brain dances as you can. So you gather that memory basis and those experiences so that it's harder for you to stand out. And it also seems like after the dive, like, another thing I've realized, like, listening to that portion, this is just me talking OC meta right now, right? Is that maybe they have more control over their memory than we do. Like, where ours are a mess because of our biology, theirs are much more, like, refined and formatted and clean that they can work with it better. So, yes, they can draw on experiences that aren't theirs at all, or they can completely incorporate them into themselves and blend in. And that's insane to me.
Brain shorts, though.
That's insane. And I was just thinking, like, it could be possible to just you could have just grabbed her, taken her out, and just handed her a bunch of, like, nice memories of us, and she would be exactly who we need her to be. A loyal servant to the end.
True. I was really wondering what the fuck you guys were gonna do there.
We were
in what regard?
I was always on the, I don't want to risk that thing having, like, some kind of tracking software or anything in it that's, like, maybe some subconscious thing that it's just gonna go back to wherever it's supposed to go. I didn't want to risk that at all. So leaving it behind was always the like primary option for me. But to leave its memory of us was like optimal decision. Don't want it to remember our faces at the very least. I don't want like, you know, its owner coming back, being a decent brain runner and going like, alright, fuck it, let's see what's in your head. Alright, got the faces. I know who was here.
Honestly, if we didn't do anything with her fucking brain, a character after he came out of that room probably was like, alright, are we leaving? Good.
Okay.
And then if nothing happened, that character probably like snapped her neck.
Yeah, just kill her. Yeah, that was a, that was an option I was playing in Complex's head, was just shoot her in a fucking head.
I was wondering if anyone was going to just fucking blast her, or if somebody was... I was kind of thinking that Desmond might take her as a fuck butler, you know?
Desmond was very close to just taking her as a fuck butler.
Oh, God.
A butler, if you will.
Yeah, yep. Yeah. Desmond, stop trying to fuck the pseudo-human.
Look, I wasn't.
You definitely were, you weren't trying to fuck
them. I was sitting there thinking, like, out of characters, like, my character's high in serotonin, he fucking wants this fucking shit to be over, and he probably would just immediately gone for the...
Well, it's not that you're high on it, it's that you're definitely attracted to her, you want to be there, you want to be in the situation, but, like, you start to, once you become aware of it, it's like, I think it's more like, oh yeah, maybe I should walk away from this.
Yeah, like my character's like physically aware that he's being manipulated. Like his actual acting as agent is like, hey, what the fuck is going on with my biometrics? Oh, you have higher serotonin. Yep. Nope,
yeah, you want to fuck her. Like, oh, right. That's what that feels like. Complex just knows when he's being seduced because he does a lot of seducing in his time. I know when I'm being seduced. Stop it.
Unfortunately, Ralph's never going to get his pen pal.
Ralph is just a happy old boy.
Ralph is just like a puppet for Hartman now, I think.
Give or take, yeah.
I forget, did we take Ralph?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes, we did.
It was in Haruna's apartment, and it was... We realized that Hartman had like upgraded his ability to process.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I thought we like left her off there.
Nope. We yoinked the boy up. He came with us.
Well, time to start programming his murder bot AI.
No, we're not having another murder bot.
Nope. But he'll be our murder bot.
That's bold.
I know we always say that, but they're not really our murder bot.
They're their own murder bot.
Okay, he'll be fucking Hartman's murder bot.
You see, you're still making him owned by someone, and that's the problem.
He's a robot.
What is it with your obsession with owning people?
Well, you see, Complex is a black Nazi who believes in slave ownership.
What?
Oh. Like what? That one guy.
That guy. What? No.
Complex is like definitely that Complex shot from Panzer Division.
There goes Complex posting on Nude America.
Not Nude Africa.
Oh yeah, no, it's Nude America now.
It's Nude America now.
But yeah, Nude Africa.
What was the term for those people again? Fucking. It, I forgot what it was called.
What?
No, there was a term for like these really like return to Africa kind of black people, and I forgot what the term is on YouTube for them.
There's a term for that?
Yeah.
Oh, of course there is.
There is. I'll have you know, I'm abundantly racist, and I ain't never heard this term before.
I think you're making racist. I hate everyone
abundantly racist.
Oh my god.
Separationists?
No.
I actually have no idea what you are talking. I don't think I've ever heard a term for somebody who wants to go back. I don't think I...
Is it Hoteps? I think it's Hotep. Hold on. Oops. Yeah, so it's Afrocentricity. Okay, so it's like those like super pro-black, anti-progress people. Yeah, they're Hoteps. That's the term I'm thinking of. Complex is not a Hotep. Yeah.
All right, so here's a question. Is that an acronym?
I don't think it is. I think it's just, it's based off of another word.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
An Egyptian word.
They focus on ancient Egypt as a source of black pride.
There you go. Oh, is that like the fucking, the source of the We Was Kangs movement?
No, because We Was Kangs is a racist parody of them. So yeah, it's where those guys got that from and started parodizing it. Yeah. Yeah. So like, if you look at the chain of like of things taken too far, yeah, that's where it comes from.
All right. We're going to call it a game there.
Yeah, I think we're wrapped.
Yeah.
Feel free to stick around if you want, but...
What's a Nubian?
What's
a Nubian, man? You... Oh, wait, bitch, you almost made me laugh.
That made me piss my pants.
What about you? I didn't know you were going to scream Black Rage. I almost pissed my pants.
I feel like I'm desperately missing context here.
It's from Chasing Amy.
Yeah.
I'm glad I'm in context now.
Grigsby.
It's a great movie.
Grigsby. I keep saying it out loud. Okay. 3XP. Alright. Imagine
3XP for Complex, 24 AXP for everyone else.
Yeah. That's what I like to see, baby. I like my friends to get up in the world. I want them to get problems.
3XP for everybody.
Yeah.
Right. Except for Complex. 1XP for. No.
Here's your big brain idea. The Japanese spy government, secret government, shadow government actually nuked Hong Kong because they were producing a technology that they wanted to produce, aka these Morganas and...
The artificial people?
Want. Yep. And then they're like, nope, y'all ain't gonna do that. And we know that the fire bomb will wipe those out because they're actually, you know, biological creatures now, so we can just completely remove that. And yeah, now they're gonna start capitalizing on it.
Are you saying the virus wiped them out too?
They literally wiped out Hong Kong over a corporate feud. Okay, I'm going to bed.
Yeah. Ding, 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 ding.
See, told you.
Nailed it. Good job.
You got it. But there is a little bit more beyond that. But yeah.
We'll be traveling there to find it out. Don't worry.
You pretty much got the right of it. So one little nuance about exactly how it all went down that makes it interesting. But yeah.
The emperor met somebody over there and said, I don't like you, I do not like you. And
there was a carrier?
No, yeah. Not quite.
There was a carrier for the plague.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. You don't necessarily...
Yeah, a bomb.
Well, I mean... You don't necessarily need a bomb to spread a plague. You can have you could drop a person on an island and kill that whole island population.
It's more to do with the nature of the plague.
Oh,
I did tell you there's some interesting there's some interesting characteristics about the plague itself.
Like the melting.
Like what?
Yeah. Blood coming out of their eyes and ears. Skin was basically falling off.
Hey, so question. Did replicants use like pseudo blood, the ones from the aliens franchise, like all the androids and that look human, basically have organs, they have white synthetic blood.
No, their blood looks red.
The blood looks red. Okay,
but it's not human blood.
It's not human blood.
Good night.
Interesting. 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 Interesting, I'm writing this down.
Write that down. Later.